We're getting set for the NFL wild card playoff game here in Seattle. And as always, the Visa SkyCam is here to provide the compelling views of all the action as the Rams take on the Seahawks at Qwest Field in Seattle. Seahawks are in the playoffs for the second straight year under Mike Holmgren. He's with Susie right now.
Well, it's been a work in progress. Mike Holmgren, a Super Bowl winning coach, but has yet to win a playoff game here with Seattle in 6 years. How has that been for you?
Well, I take them a game at a time. I'd like to win it. I'd like to win it one this year. It'd be very special. It's been 20 years since Seattle's won a playoff game. I think we're about due.
Rams beat you guys twice this year. What have you said to your players to convince them that they can beat the Rams today?
Well, I thought the game here, we had a game we could have won, Susie, and we didn't. But both games have been very competitive, and usually turnovers decide the game. Today will be no different.
What makes them so dangerous on offense?
Well, you know, they have great skill at their skill positions, and they really believe in what they're doing. So great players make great plays for them.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
All right, Susie, when we come back to Seattle, it's the Rams and the Seahawks as the playoffs begin.
ABC Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Welcome back to a sold-out Qwest Field in Seattle, the first game of the playoffs. The Rams have not been a good road team. The last five games away from St. Louis, 0-5, and they have been romps. The last time they won here in Seattle.
And this is an area on the special teams where the Rams, as prolific an offense as they have, as dynamic as they are offensively, their special teams have not been up to the standards. And so often in the playoffs, special teams make a huge difference.
They stink.
Okay. You said
their special teams stink.
They're not that good.
Josh Brown to kick to Avion Kayson.
They're ugly and they stink.
Hey, hey, hey.
The playoffs are underway in Seattle. Kayson from the 4. Taken down at the 24. Let's meet the Rams offense.
Marc Bulger, West Virginia University.
Marshall Faulk, San Diego State.
Joey Goodspeed, Notre Dame.
Torrey Big Game Holt, North Carolina State.
Isaac Bruce, University of Memphis.
Brandon Manumaleuna, Arizona.
Orlando Pace, The Ohio State University.
Tom Newton, Western Michigan University.
Andy McCollum, Toledo.
Adam Timmerman, South Dakota State.
Blaine Saipia, Colorado State.
The downside of the kick return team is they don't get good field position. The upside is this offense doesn't need good field position. Marc Bulger, even though he missed 3 full games, nearly passed for 4,000 yards. Bulger out in the flat to Faulk, and he's pushed out of bounds. Let's take a look at the Seahawks defense.
G.K. O'Keefe, Purdue. Cedric Woodard, Texas Longhorn.
Rashad Moore, Huntsville, Alabama.
Antonio Cochran.
I will try to get back to that defensive unit in a moment. That was no gain on the little dump-off pass to Faulk. And it's 2nd and 10 for the Rams. And listen to the crowd. Steven Jackson is into the backfield with Faulk, and he goes in motion. Bulger with time. Faulk out of the backfield. First down as he reaches the 37-yard line.
Well, the one thing about this Ram football team is that they give Marc Bulger an awful lot of time. Just take a look at the time that he has, and I'm going to tell you right now, Marshall Faulk was not the primary receiver. Watch the time he has. He just looks in the pocket. There is a hole to throw the ball. Look at the hole. Bang. Right on the arms of Marshall Faulk, and he gets a first down. That's easy.
And Faulk for years has been such a brilliant receiver as well as an outstanding running back. He'll go in motion this time. Bulger right on the money to Torrey Holton. Torrey Holton to the 11-yard line.
Oh, this was unbelievable. Ken Lucas and Michael Bulger just got trapped with a void between them, the safety and the corner. Marshall Faulk out in the flat gets that kind of attention. You see him outside of Torrey Holton. Now up the field. In the middle is Michael Bulger. Michael Bulger has been told, don't break on the ball till it's thrown. I don't believe he can be successful unless he tries to anticipate a little bit. If he's going to be caught in his back pedal all afternoon, it's going to be a long day for that Seattle defense.
52 yards for Torrey Holton, who is number one all time in yards per game for a receiver. He averages 85 a game, already has 52.
Last time these two teams played in Seattle, Mike Martz started that game with 13 straight passes. Already today, he's thrown three. So, I mean, it just, that's what Mike Martz does. Now, Mike Holmgren on the other side, he would like to get his hands on the ball and control it a little bit more. But if Martz wants to keep on putting it up with this offense of his, he's going to force Mike Holmgren out of what he would like to do.
Well, what he needs to do is what he told us 2 days ago that he was going to do, and that's the blitz, Bulger. And you can't just send five. You've got to send six and seven.
Steven Jackson is the running back. Bulger under pressure, and down he goes. Cattavini's the middle linebacker, applied the pressure up the middle.
All right, just take a look. And here's what happens. This is a play action pass here. But the linebacker, Cattavini, doesn't stay with it. He just goes. And when he does,
Cheeky O'Keefer did a
He doesn't sit on the line of scrimmage and wait. He goes right after Bulger. And this is what they have to do. They cannot sit back and wait.
Drop play, Jackson. Excellent pursuit by Seattle. They'll take him down at the 10-yard line. Marcus Trufant and Marquand Manuel on the tackle. Jackson, the rookie out of Oregon State, not only the heir apparent to Marshall Faulk, but splitting time with him already.
You know, he may be the heir apparent, but very few running backs can bring to the game the versatility that Marshall Faulk can do. Steven Jackson is a much bigger back. He's 20, 25 pounds heavier than Marshall Faulk. So you won't see him split out like Marshall can and does.
Isaiah Kazavinsky is the injured Seahawk. They have been devastated by injuries at the linebacker core. We'll be back in a moment. Back in Seattle amid chants of defense, the Rams, third and goal.
Flag down, delay. It's on the offense.
Prior to the snap, false start, 76, offense. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
And that is their all-world left tackle, Orlando Pace.
And that is, as the fans are referred to here in Seattle, as the 12th man. The crowd noise here can be a big factor. We saw it on that play. It can also help Seattle's offense to slow down that pass rush once they get the ball.
We heard it in the opening.
I couldn't hear you in the opening. I don't know. It was so loud.
The Rams are going to take another timeout.
And that's two. They have burned on the opening drive. We'll be back to Seattle in a moment. Usually we would say the noise is a huge factor because we're indoors, but we're outdoors and Marc Bulger cannot hear here in Seattle.
He's going to have to figure out a way possibly to cover the ear holes, maybe bend towards the ground to hear the communications from the sidelines better.
What? Seven defensive backs have checked in for Seattle. Bulger over the middle, touchdown Torrey Holton. They needed eight instead of seven.
It's amazing to me. I just don't think you can, with the receivers they have And with the ability of Marc Bulger to throw the football, the worst thing you can do is give him time. Torrey Holt just goes down, and he's running in between the zones. Nobody lays a hand on him. He just goes flying right inside and on Babineau, and boom, touchdown.
They burned two timeouts. They had a couple of penalties. They had a sack. But in the end, Bulger is 4 for 4 for 79 yards and a touchdown.
Did he make the catch, Mike? That's going to be the question.
Well, the fans went absolutely nuts, and what they were screaming at. And then Holmgren actually, did he throw his flag? He had to.
And catch for a touchdown.
They're going to see if Torrey Holt has possession of the ball when he goes into the end zone. There's the throw. There's the ball.
Oh, that's a catch.
Ooh. Hadn't hit the ground yet, has it?
No, it hasn't.
When you just take a look at his left arm, and it's underneath the ball. Look at it underneath the ball.
I don't know, Paul. I'm sorry. Right there, it looks like the top part of the football gets to the ground.
You better have something more conclusive than that play.
And that is the key, because it has been ruled a catch and a touchdown on the field, so they have to find enough to overturn that rule.
Yes. Irrefutable? Is that the word?
That's correct.
But I'll tell you what, the thing that sells is for Torrey Holt, and you really, you know, give him a lot of credit. He got that left arm underneath the ball, and it just really looked like a catch. Here it comes again. Look at his left arm. Look at the ball.
Ball's on the ground.
Yo. The ball can hit the ground if the receiver has control. That is part of the rule.
I don't believe he ever really has control. I think the ball hits the ground right there. The ball is on the ground. He does not have control of the football. If I was reviewing this, I would think that it would be an incompletion.
I think it's a touchdown.
So do
Paul,
I.
You get the tiebreaker.
I think it's a touchdown because
Coleman gets the tiebreaker. Look at the end of this.
Watch his hand underneath the ball.
Now he moves it.
His hand is under the ball the entire time.
All right, here you go. I think he moves his hand late, Paulie. See, the ball down. Now watch his right hand slide.
You know, it would be nice after 20 in the 23rd game that you got one right.
I'm trying. And I knew you wouldn't agree with me anyway, so what was the difference?
But I tell you what, it takes a lot to overturn these babies.
Well, Walt Coleman, now keep in mind, Walt Coleman was the official in the championship game a year ago when everybody did a lot of bumping and chucking. So, you know, he was. And also, the other thing we ought to note about this officiating crew, this crew has been together all year.
Right.
It used to be all-star crews that would come in and do the playoffs. And I think that's a great decision by the league to be able to allow the men to work, get to know one another, and then work the playoffs together.
Torrey Holt saying, I got it.
You got the wrong hand under it, Torrey.
After reviewing the play, the receiver caught the ball. The ball did touch the ground, but the ball never moved, so it's a completed catch for a touchdown.
I think it's a good call.
You know, I'm gonna tell you, the ball hits the ground, but Michael even explained it to you before and to everyone. As long as he has control of the football, the ball can hit the ground. And that was just great work by Torrey Holt. That's why he's a Pro Bowler, and that's why he catches everything in the area. But the thing that really gets me is, and in two pass patterns to him, how can he be that open?
Well, I did say it hit the ground. No, you're right. I mean, I just don't believe, and we saw both routes that he, the big catch for 52 yards and the touchdown, I just don't believe that Seattle can sit in a zone against these receivers and this quarterback.
This is the most exquisitely designed passing game
ruthless.
In the NFL.
Ruthless.
Jeff Wilkins for the point after. The Rams open fast the way they normally do. It's 7-0 in Seattle. St. Louis with the first quarter lead, 75 yards on only 6 plays, 3 minutes and 27 seconds. It did cost them 2 timeouts, and Seattle loses one as well and a challenge.
It doesn't matter how many timeouts St. Louis has.
No, never has.
It really doesn't.
No, they don't care. Mike ought to just, like, sell them.
You know, eBay.
eBay. Put them on eBay for next week if somebody wants to purchase one of the Rams timeouts.
Morris and Evans are deep. Morris, shy of the 30. Let's meet the Seahawks offense.
Matt Hasselbeck, he's very inventive. Boston.
Sean Alexander, the University of Alabama.
Max Strong, Georgia.
Jerry Rice, Mississippi Valley State University.
The Exact, Florida Gate.
Itula Mealy, Laie Elementary.
Walter Jones, Florida State.
Steve Hutchinson, Michigan.
Rob Toback, Wazoo.
Chris Gray, Auburn University.
Florida Womack, Mississippi State.
Well, the Rams have come out and done what they do best. Now will Seattle feed the ball to Shaw and Alexander to start it off? Hasselbeck to throw on first down, has a little bit of pressure, throws, knocked up in the air and intercepted. Darryl Jackson had a hand on it, and it is intercepted by the Rams, Travis Fisher, and that has been the bane of Seattle's passing attack all year. Dropped balls.
The final thing I said in the opening was, and pray that the receivers can hold on to the football. Look at this. This ball hits him right in the hands. It's a magnificent interception. But I'll tell you what, you got to get tired as a quarterback throwing to these receivers and have drop as many balls as they drop.
Especially when you hit them right in between the numbers. You have to keep throwing, but you're right, Paul.
And the Rams had only 6 interceptions all year long. That ties for the worst ever in a non-strike season. So what a way for their secondary to start the playoff. Jackson is the tailback. Cuts it outside after a hesitation. Takes it to the 35-yard line.
You know, it almost looks like Seattle defensively on the line has decided that they don't want to try and penetrate to put pressure. It's like they take a step or so. They're waiting for the Rams to set into pass protection and then try and knock the ball down. They're not really getting any pressure on Marc Bulger at all.
Mike Holmgren told us a couple of days ago, he said, let me tell you something. We cannot get to this guy with 4 people. We cannot get to this guy with 4 people. They've got a sense of people, and they've got to send it from the outside.
3 wide receivers, Kevin Curtis, the third man in the slot. Bulger, pump fake. Down the sideline for Holden. That one is intercepted at the 2. Picked off by Ken Hamlin, the safety. Came over in double coverage. And the secondary that had 23 picks during the regular season gets a huge one here.
Marc Bulger just doesn't get the separation. He tries to pump fake and move Hamlin, but he doesn't. Ken Lucas is staying with, just goes up and gets the ball, makes the interception.
Big defensive stand by Seattle. They dodge a big bullet. Welcome back to Seattle, where the Seahawks will take over at their own 4-yard line after the interception. Marc Bulger still hasn't had a pass hit the ground, but unfortunately for him, that was caught by Seattle.
Listen to this. In 4.5 minutes, we've had 3 timeouts, 1 challenge, 2 interceptions, and a touchdown. Hello!
When we just started.
That's right. 4.5 minutes.
And we've only got 4. That's right. Now, do you come out and run the football, or you try and throw it again?
Quick out to Jackson. Jeremetrius Butler is there to help him down at the 10.
What makes an interception is teammates. Watch the job Ken Lucas does. See him down the bottom just long enough to force Holt to hesitate to allow Ken Lucas to get over to make the play. See him just enough to make him to hesitate. That's a terrific job of a corner and a safety working together. High risk, high reward.
Sean Alexander for a couple up to the 7. That'll leave them a 3rd and 2. Jimmy Kennedy on the stop for the Rams. 1 yard short of winning the NFL rushing title. 1,696 yards, a single yard behind Curtis Martin.
You know, and that thing's all in the past now. And if you take a look at Sean Alexander, where they really love to run is to the left, where Walter Jones, the all-pro tackle, is.
Hasselbeck throws and incomplete. Jackson continued straight down the field, and Hasselbeck threw inside.
How about this? When you're not even looking, if you're Darryl Jackson, you come off the line, the quarterback's going to throw you the football. You don't even see it go past you. I mean, you talk about a guy not having his head in the game. This is phenomenal. Now, granted, he's been hurt a lot, hasn't practiced much in 6 weeks, but still, it's game time.
There have been some odd things with wide receivers out here. Sean McDonald waits in his own 44 for Ken Walters' punt. Driven all the way back to the 41. Still looking for a block. And taken out of bounds at the 40. A long way to run to lose a yard. Let's check in with Susie.
Well, Mike, what an eventful start for Marc Bulger. 4 of 5 for 79 yards, a touchdown and a pick. He admitted as recently as October, he still felt overwhelmed with the game plan. Today, it is 300 plays thick. Consider, though, this just his first full season as a starter. This is the most complex offense in football. Marc's telling us last night, the metamorphosis this season, incredible. Marc is seeing everything, doing things in the game that Marc never thought he could do. And Marc explaining he used to be mentally drained, now it's just physical.
Susie, it's amazing to listen to Mike Marc say, not only can I compare him with Kurt Warner, but he's better than Kurt Warner. Jackson picks up a couple. Torrey Holt told us there's more behind Bulger's quiet demeanor than we see.
Marc is a very competitive guy. It's funny. He's cool and calm, and that's good. I call him lukewarm. That's good. You got to have that in with your quarterback. But he's very confident, and he works on being the best teammate and player that he can be to help us.
Torrey Holt's a very interesting guy, isn't he? Yeah, very bright, very bright guy.
Well, Bulger said if he wants to call me lukewarm, that's okay.
Bulger straight back to throw. There's the out, and because Isaac Bruce fell down, Trufant actually had a shot at the pick and couldn't hold it.
Now, this is what you're going to see. This footing will be different for the Ram receiver. You see Isaac Bruce push up. If this is in the dome, his right foot does not slip out. Marcus Trufant almost gets his hand on this one, but now all of a sudden, Isaac Bruce has to think to himself, all right, I have to be a little more cautious when I come out of my breaks. It may be dry, but it's not that great a footing.
Third and 8.
Here they come. They have to come.
Protected well. Curtis and a flag down. Intended for Kevin Curtis. He never saw it. But this is going to be a hold, I believe, against the Seattle secondary.
Holding, 21, defense. 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Ken Lucas.
I talked to Ray Rhodes yesterday at practice, the defensive coordinator of the Seahawks. He told me he wants his young corners to challenge these wide receivers. Now, remember, this is the playoffs. It was because of the playoffs that there was a rule emphasis change when it came to dealing with wide receivers. And, you know, Ray Bob, as he's affectionately called by his teammates, says, hey, look, want you guys to go out and challenge him.
Well, that time they sent 6 guys, and they made Bulger throw the ball when he didn't want to throw the ball. They can't sit there. 4 guys can't get off this line of scrimmage and get to the quarterback.
Boy, the crowd saw that replay and did not like the call at all. End around Isaac Bruce.
Oh, Chad Brown.
Beautifully played by Chad Brown.
Let me tell you something. If you're going to run an end around, that is not a reverse, folks. That's an end around. And if you're going to run it, don't run it at the veteran Chad Brown. Run it someplace else. Watch number 94 stay home and then come back inside and make the tackle. There's a guy that they have missed for a long time. They have had so many injuries in the linebacking position. They actually had, at one time, 3 middle linebackers playing. 2 of them outside, 1 inside.
And we saw Kazavinsky go down earlier in this quarter for him.
Chad Brown in his 12th year still has that great motor. Marshall Faulk trying to cut it up from the right side. He's in Seattle territory at the 47. Michael Boulware made the tackle. Marshall Faulk, obviously not the player he once was. Career lows in carries, 195, and only 3 touchdowns this year.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, I don't even remember Marshall Faulk this year. I remember all the other years.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, I'll tell you
right.
But I think if the Rams are going anywhere in the playoffs, he's going to have to make his presence felt.
Third and four. And Bulger caught by the middle of that pass rush and dragged down. Bernard and Chad Brown coming up the middle.
Michael, I'm sorry, but this is what they really have to do. Now, Chad Brown's the number 94, is coming up the middle. But look in the middle of the field. Rocky Bernard, 99, is the first guy to get there. Yes, you did. And that's what you have to do with Bulger. You've got to take him out of any kind of a rhythm that he gets into.
And Rocky's obviously been up all night working on that little celebration. Like that. Bobby Engram will go deep to take the punt. Takes a good Seattle bounce. Out of bounds near the 25-yard line. Seattle has stood up a couple of times on defense. Can they get their offense going?
Wow. How'd this happen?
I told them if they shoveled, I let them use their new phones to talk to their friends as much as they want.
They can do that anyway. We've got the Verizon Wireless Family Share Plan with the N.
Yeah, well, they don't know that.
Looks cold.
It's freezing. I ain't going out there.
Sign up for the Family Share Plan, and the whole family can make unlimited in calls to each other and any other Verizon Wireless customer from within the America's Choice coverage area. Plus, don't miss our great deals on camera phones starting at just $29.99.
Hurt myself.
Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
It's wonderful.
It's incredible.
It's something only Wendy's could do.
It's amazing.
Introducing Combo Choices.
Oh, thanks.
Choose fries, chili, baked potato, side, or Caesar side salad at no extra cost. Dave Thomas knew his customers liked the choice.
A combo with a side salad.
So choose Wendy's. It's better here. Our pickup window is open till midnight or later.
So, you're a former pirate with no formal training. And you've got an eye patch, a hook, and a parrot on your shoulder.
Arg!
And all you can say is arg.
Arg!
Okay, McClure Brothers need some help with their shipping. It says they use FedEx.com, so it's really easy. I'm confident you can handle it.
Arg!
Terrific.
Thanks to FedEx.com's online shipping center, shipping has never been easier.
Coming up, we hope you'll join Al Michaels and John Madden for the second half of our Wild Card Saturday doubleheader. The NFL's top rusher, Curtis Martin, will lead the Jets against Drew Brees, LaDainian Tomlinson, and the AFC West champion Chargers next here on ABC. And two outstanding running backs who had brilliant seasons. Curtis Martin led the NFL, wanted to show that a back over 30 could still get it done. Boy, did he ever. And LaDainian led the league in rushing touchdowns.
I think LaDainian Tomlinson is the best back in football.
From the 25, Alexander picks up 5 to the 30.
That was an excellent call by Mike Holmgren. He needs to settle his football team down. The first pass that was thrown bounces up in the air, was intercepted. The third time, the last time they had the ball on third down, you throw it to Daryl Jackson, he's not looking. Slow this game down. You cannot go throw to throw with the Rams. You're going to lose if you try and match up that way against them.
Second and 5. Alexander nowhere to go. Then he cuts it back. Sean Alexander turned a loss of 5 into a gain of 5.
Leonard Little, number 91, is a great defensive end. He's got all the speed in the world, but watch what he does. Number 91, right there, he goes running by. He gets himself too far down the line of scrimmage. Here, you'll see him right here. 91 is Leonard Little. Watch him go by Alexander. Now, Alexander comes back. He knocks off his own man, and Alexander picks up 4 yards. If you're that, when you're that fast and you know you got that great speed, and we've seen a lot of them, man, I'm going to tell you what, you got to learn how to stay at home.
Third and inches. Seattle still looking for its first down with 5:43 on the first quarter clock.
If you go back a week ago when it was third and inches on the goal line, Mike Holmgren called a quarterback sneak, didn't give it to Sean Alexander. I'd be surprised if he doesn't sneak this one as well with his big young quarterback.
And it was amazing to have people criticize him for that. His first job is to win games. If a quarterback sneaks the best call, that's what he called.
Needed to win to be able to play here in Seattle.
The middle is open. All he has to do is just step forward. He got a first down.
Alexander will get it and have the first down. Let's check in with Susie as flag drops.
Oh, man, you got holding. He's calling it on the defense. They're calling defensive holding on a running play.
Holding, 79, defense. 5-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
That's Ryan Pickett. Now let's check in with Susie.
Well, Mike, the thought is, why the heck wouldn't you be running Sean Alexander? He's been a wrecking crew against the Rams this season. Week 5, 150 yards rushing. Week 10, 176. That total is the most yards rushing for any player against any team this season. Adam Archuleta called it the biggest slap in the face for a defense. That's how you forge your identity, by stopping the run. Sean does a great job of finding the holes, and when he reaches that third level, hits a safety, forget it.
And yet, Susie, the coaches are well aware that in spite of that success on the ground, they lost the first two games. And in the second game, they only scored one touchdown.
But Sean Alexander gives you what every quarterback and every offense wants. On first down, when he runs the ball, he gets about at least four. Now you're sitting in that position of second and six where you can do almost anything you want.
Yeah, and the problem is you throw it to your receivers, you're crossing your fingers and hope they catch it.
It's true.
They have not thrown a pass anywhere close to Jerry Rice so far. Everything has gone to the other side, to Jackson. And we have not seen Corn Robinson. Hasselbeck. First down and more to the Rams, 38-yard line. Gain of 17.
I tell you, this is heads up, but I'm going to tell you something. Just take a look at what Matt Hasselbeck does here. He sees there's no place to go, and he steps up and gets the first down. But I'm going to tell you what's amazing. Darryl Jackson runs downfield. Watch him. He never looks back at the quarterback. Look at this. He never looks back. Not once.
Now, remember before, when he threw it to him, he wasn't looking. Darryl Jackson needs something to get his head in this game.
Alexander. Well, didn't that last one tell you he's not the primary receiver? And he does. I'm not excusing it, but he's not the primary receiver, so he's not paying attention.
But, Mike, forget about it. Sooner or later, if you're a football player and you're in between those lines, you got to turn around, especially if you are a receiver when a pass is called.
I understand.
That was hard for me to believe. I'm watching him run down the field, and he never turned his head. I'm thinking, what are you doing?
And here's a guy they invested a lot of money in.
And he's had a whale of a year, 87 catches, almost 1,200 yards. They'll whistle this one dead, and it looked like Porchak Womack, the right tackle, moved early.
Prior to the snap, false start, 77, offense. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Let's take a look at the Rams' defense.
Leonard Little, Tennessee.
Ryan Pickett, The Ohio State University.
Jimmy Kennedy, Penn State.
Anthony Hargrove, Port Charlotte High School.
Tommy Pollard, Florida State.
Robert Thomas, UCLA.
Pisatino Isamoah, Hawaii.
Jeremetrius Butler, Dallas Carter High School.
Adam Archuleta, Arizona State.
Antoine Edwards, Clemson.
Travis Fisher, Godfrey High School.
Second and 14, and Antoine Edwards, one of a half dozen guys they've had playing free safety. They picked him up from the Dolphins in the middle of the year. Hasselbeck under pressure, throws short to Jackson. And Jackson pushed out of bounds by Fisher.
Now this is heads-up play by the quarterback, and this was all done by him. Matt Hasselbeck steps up. He could have thrown a little dump pass to his left, but he knew that wasn't going anywhere. Watch him. He'll look. Now he sees the left. Now I'm not going to go there. And hold on. Here's the line of scrimmage. Let me get it back to Jackson.
And so often quarterbacks, as they scramble around, they lower their heads and decide to run. He did a nice job of disciplining himself, looking downfield, knowing where everybody is, and getting the ball out of his hand.
Third down and a long yard. Alexander was the man who went in motion. Hasselbeck tipped up in the air and incomplete. Atulamili got a hand on it. Jeremetrius Butler came in and nearly had the pick.
You know, I want to go back to the beginning of that play, guys. Daryl Jackson didn't know where to line up on that play. Now there's the throw. There's the right arm around. Everybody's calling for a flag. Mealy does a good job of finding it and almost getting it. Watch this. Now, they had to tell Daryl Jackson where to go in this formation. He's just not in this game. You know, now he runs the route, and he decides to look this time, which is a novelty for him.
Well, that's really odd, isn't it? Josh Brown will try a 47-yard field goal attempt. And got it. So Seattle overcomes some mistakes on that drive to get a field goal and get on the board down 7-3. Wild card weekend, of course, the Rams, the Seahawks, the Vikings, and the Packers. And the Eagles host the lower seed a week from now. The Falcons will host the higher seed in the NFC. And, of course, I don't think there is a single team in there that has a lock on anything or a single team that can't win the entire NFC.
I think the Philadelphia Eagles have become the great question mark because since Terrell Owens got hurt, they have not had to play a meaningful football game. So you really don't know how they're going to react. So you just are not sure what you're going to get out of it. I mean, Green Bay could catch on fire. Heck, if the Rams come out and play like they did on the first drive, they could be unbelievable.
I'll tell you one thing about Philadelphia, though. You're going to see some defense.
I know one thing. Andy Reid is not excited about getting to the NFC Championship game without going to the next level.
That's right.
If he can get his ball club there. And then how about Michael Vick? The Vick factor. You know, who stops him, maybe?
Avion Kayson is deep for the Rams. High, short kick. Kayson on the run at the 8. Runs into his own man, then runs into a swarm of Seattle defenders. Let's check in with Susie.
Well, we got a little taste of why they call Torrey Holt. Big game already, a touchdown today. First receiver in NFL history with 5 straight 1,300-yard seasons. He told me that it represents so much hard work, dedication, and fulfillment because it's what he dreamed about since he was a little kid, watching Jerry Rice, Art Monk, Lynn Swan, and to be the first in history to do something when all those guys had paved the way. Man, he says an unbelievable feeling, and he wants to thank all of them for inspiring him to be the receiver he is today.
And now Susie's breaking all their records.
Well, you're not going to break Jerry Rice's record.
Not for longevity, you're not. Jackson dancing a little bit. Takes it up to the 28-yard line. He is number one in NFL history. Yards per game. 85 yards a game over Moss, Harrison, and Jerry Rice. Is fourth, and all those guys, thanks to Rice's longevity, are contemporary.
One of the things about these stats to me, which is quite unique, is every one of them is still active. It's not one of the guys that happened that has played before. Every one of those are active players.
Holt and Bruce both come to the same side. Jackson behind Goodspeed lowers his shoulder, takes it up near the 32-yard line.
Wait a minute, I'm watching. 4 or 5 running plays now. Calm down, Joseph.
No.
That March yesterday said the only way you win in the National Football League, touchdowns come from throwing the ball, not running the ball.
But it's interesting, Mike's philosophy. He likes to change the tempo of a game. He starts out real fast. Now he slows it down, sort of lulls you back in, and then all of a sudden here comes the explosion. The game for him has a psychology, and for Mike Holmgren, it's a bit more methodical.
Well, they got 6 defensive backs in the game, and you better send at least one of them.
3rd and 3. Blitz coming. They pick it up, and Bulger throws complete to Holt. 1st down at the 45. Mike Martz, a lightning rod for criticism, but boy, is he fun to watch run an offense, especially this offense.
Well, and you look at here, you got Torrey Holt one-on-one, and every time that Bulger sees this matchup, you can be assured that he's going to throw the ball there.
That's the end of the first quarter. The Rams over the Seahawks, 7-3. ABC's NFL Wildcard Saturday continues after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Not in our house, buddy. Not today.
Oh, no! This ain't going down.
Not today, not even. Oh,
no. Not today.
Not today.
Not tomorrow.
Nobody coming in here.
Visa, official card of the NFL and the house of the Super Bowl champion New England Patriots, where they accept no other card to get you in. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
I can't believe he swallowed my cell phone.
Sounds like he's on hold.
Your wait time is 46 minutes.
It's peak hours.
Ooh, daytime charges.
And you could be roaming.
Is your wireless company charging you a fortune?
I'm going in.
Come to T-Mobile and talk whenever nationwide.
Whenever.
Now get 1,000 whenever minutes, free nights and weekends, just $45.99.
T-Mobile, get more.
It's not drugs.
You have a problem.
I do not have a problem.
It isn't alcohol.
I got a big, big problem.
It's the addiction that Jim can't fight.
You disgust me.
Gonna help. Gotta wind up more.
All new according to Jim, Tuesday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Football sponsored locally by Toyota. Moving forward, Toyota.
This is the Toyota Camry. It's the best-selling car in America. You can lease it for $199 a month for 36 months with $1,869 due at signing. See? In beautiful black and white. If a down payment doesn't work for you, you can lease a Camry for $249 a month. An extra $50 a month, but you drive away paying nothing except the first month's payment. That's it. You want one? See your Toyota dealer.
The Camry, one of 17 Toyotas moving you forward.
Welcome back to Qwest Field in Seattle. Beautiful weather for a playoff game. We have been blessed. No rain, no snow, more moderate temperatures, and St. Louis doing what it does best, racking up 115 yards in the first quarter. And the Rams have reached their own 45, first and 10. Bulger going deep again. This one for Curtis to the 5.
Boy, are they picking on Michael Boulware, number 28, the rookie safety who has converted himself from a linebacker to a safety, and the conversion is still in process. That time, Marc Bulger just looked off. Michael Boulware was just flat-footed.
I don't care. I don't care who's running the patterns. It matters who's throwing it. Look at the blocking of this offensive line. You got four guys that aren't even close to him, and he has all day to find your wide receiver Curtis down the middle of the field and let it fly.
6 for 8, 142 yards in one quarter and one play for Bulger. Marshall Faulk near the 1.
Now keep in mind, Marc Bulger threw for 450 against the Jets just 6 days ago. And to watch him mature, people, I think, have to understand the complexity of the offense that is run and the rhythm that he has with the receivers. This offense has no audibles in it. Everything is sight adjusted. And what I mean by that is the receivers and the quarterback have to see the same thing to make adjustments on the routes. Great discipline, great study habits are required to be able to do that.
Faulk, touchdown, walked in from the 2. Joey Goodspeed led him into the hole, and there was nobody left to touch Marshall Faulk.
You could talk about their defense, the Rams, you could talk about their special teams. But look, you see Goodspeed's block there, but you take a look at this offensive line and what they're doing. I mean, they just play. You talk about five guys play as one, they actually play as one.
This is what Marshall Faulk lives for, though, to be in the playoffs, to be a part of the offense. We saw him get the ball on the first two plays of the game. Mike March has made an excellent decision getting him involved early.
Jeff Wilkins for the point after. Both touchdown drives for the Rams, 75 yards in 6 plays, and they have a 14-3 lead.
Want to get away? Now you can. Go to southwest.com for Southwest Airlines $39 to $149 internet specials to 59 destinations nationwide. Purchased by January 16th.
You are now free to move about the country.
A shift has been made, and better stories will be told. A shift has been made, and hardcore just got harder. Core. A shift has been made, and taking eight camping is only a problem for the tent. A shift has been made, and the concrete jungle is finally tamed. A shift has been made, and when you think adventure, on-road or off, think Nissan.
The playoffs are where moments are made. What's next?
Marc Bulger has already had a big first half, and he has led Seattle, or St. Louis rather, to a 14-3 lead over Seattle. That drive took only 3:33, and Falk capped it off with a touchdown run.
When the drives have 50-yard passes in them, it doesn't take very long.
No.
Or a lot of plays to get where you want to go.
Well, that's been the hallmark of this team. They don't take very long, and all year long, this has been one of the points in the game when they start to dominate, that something really silly happens on special teams. Morris out to the 28, and the flag comes in at the end of it. We'll check that in a second.
That's Michael Bulger right there. I want you to watch the route of Kevin Curtis, and then you look at Marc Bulger. He's going to look off to the left, so he's going to move number 28. There's the pump. The safety gets turned. Remember, he's a linebacker. His hips aren't going to be real quick. He isn't the center fielder he is, and he's a rookie. He's a rookie who's playing a new position, and this is only his fifth start.
And all it takes is one step in the other direction to open up enough of a lane.
And these are not the receivers that you want to practice trying to figure out where they're going to go and anticipate routes.
Well, Michael Bulger also told us yesterday, we're sitting there talking, or the day before yesterday, we were talking to him. He said, you know, I can't take any false steps. He said, and so far in this game, he has done it twice where he's taken false steps. And then false steps was exactly what Joe was talking about. When Bulger pumps, if he even flinches going towards the middle, he's done.
And he's a very bright young man, and he will get it. Hasselbeck throwing underneath. That one's behind Ingram and incomplete. And Hasselbeck, very slow to get up. Ingram had a season high a week ago, 6 catches, 79 yards. Really bailed out their passing game.
Here comes Hargrove, number 95. I believe this is the guy that's going to hit him.
You know what? Ooh, that's got to be roughing.
Kind of doubled him.
It's supposed to be roughing. Once the quarterback lets the ball go, you're only allowed a step. You can't hit him. I mean,
you're right.
That should have been roughing the quarterback if they're going to be consistent with the calls that have gone all year.
They didn't hit him in the head.
Doesn't matter.
Hasselbeck. This one, he's got it complete over the middle. That's his tight end, Atula Mealy.
I'll tell you what, he threw this about as hard as he could throw a football. He sees Mealy coming across the middle. Watch him wind up, Hasselbeck, and throw this thing. Wham! And he had to get it there.
Boy, you saw that go right under Ryan Pickett's number 79.
It's almost like, if you can't catch him, I'm going to make the next one stick to you. Corin Robinson is in for the first time. He is number 81, the super talented wide receiver for the Seahawks. Hasselbeck all day to throw. Gets this one to Jackson, and Jackson to the 48.
This ball, I believe, is tipped. Now, Daryl Jackson has had problems focusing. It looks like he's into the game now, and that happens to people sometimes. you get a little out of sync. But watch this. He's working. This ball gets tipped, and he still manages to focus. Daryl Jackson is back into this football game. Yep, does get tipped.
First down, Seahawks. Alexander into Rams territory at the 48-yard line. Corn Robinson is a player that a lot of people say has just such extreme talent, and they've been upset with Mike Holmgren for what they perceive as coddling a former number one draft choice. Mike Holmgren, in his defense, cares more about this young man as a human being than he does as a football player, although he would love to see him produce as that. He has been suspended twice by the team for violating team rules. He has been suspended by the NFL for violating league rules, and they are just hoping that somehow, at some point, he is going to get it.
Well, they've spotted him playing, but a bigger problem for the Seahawks right now is Sean Alexander has come off the field dangling his left shoulder. He took a shot on that last running play, or the forearm. He gets hurt right on this play. That's Archuleta coming flying up in there. And then he gets pounded on top of it.
And that leaves Maurice Morris, the third-year player out of Oregon, as the tailback. And as good as he might be, he is no Sean Alexander. There is Morris fighting for extra yardage and has it inside the 40.
I'll tell you what, old Maurice is Maurice. He's not Sean Alexander, he's Maurice. And Maurice picks up a first down. And by driving his legs and not stopping.
We talked about Sean Alexander. Sean averaged 4.8 yards a carry. Maurice averaged 4.2. So they can run the football. The Seahawks are a very balanced offense, and we're seeing it here. A great mixture of run and pass.
At the 38, with 10 minutes, 12 seconds to go, second quarter. Morris, this is going to be a holder block in the back. And it looked like it was the massive left tackle, Walter Jones, the guilty party.
I'll tell you what, if it's Walter Jones, you can't miss
holding,
it.
86, offense, 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
They'll give it to Jeremy Stevens, the tight end, but they threw it right at the feet of Walter Jones. And if Sean Alexander cannot come back in the ballgame, it would be a crushing loss, not only for this game, but any other playoff games they might be fortunate enough to be in this year. I mean, just look at the numbers.
Well, he's got 15-plus touchdowns. You see 16, 18, 16, 20. But no one in the history of football has had 15-plus touchdowns in four consecutive years. I mean, that's unbelievable.
And four of them have been receiving, so he's a very important part of their passing attack as well.
Hasselbeck with a quick out. That's only going to pick up a couple to Bobby Engram.
And this offense, the Seattle Seahawks offense, isn't like the Rams offense. They don't throw the ball down the field as far or as much or as often as the Rams do. So to pick up 20 yards, it's going to take a good three or four plays. Now Mike Holmgren's forced to call in a deeper route than he normally would like to.
And it almost, with Sean Alexander out, Joe, it almost eliminates the play action.
Second and 17 from the 45. Hasselbeck straight back. Good protection. Underneath the Corn Robinson, who fumbles the football.
And it fell right in between his legs. Oh, man.
Boy, now you've got Robbie Toback going after one of the Rams after the play. It looked like Tinoi Samoa, the linebacker.
It was.
You know what? I like the way the officiating crew is calling this game. We've seen instances where anytime a lineman would go after somebody on a pile, a flag would instantly come out. The officials are doing a nice job of controlling this game, but letting the guys play with emotion.
All right, here, Tisamoa, you see him, number 50, he's right there. And Toback comes up and just nails him. Well, that was after that.
Boy, it was a real break for Corn Robinson. That ball bounced right back into his tummy. And now Matt Hasselbeck will use Seattle's second time out of the first half.
You say you had a bar with some friends, and these guys just came out of nowhere and took your Bud Light.
Yeah, that's right.
And they gave you this.
You think you can pick them out of a lineup?
Oh, yeah. That's them.
4, 5, 6, step forward.
Run!
Some people will do anything to get the great taste of Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
A shift has been made. And the full-size truck party finally got interesting. A shift has been made. And the mid-size truck feels a whole lot bigger. A shift has been made. And when you think tough, powerful, innovative trucks, think Nissan.
Learn more about spiders at spdr.com.
Don't miss another moment. Go to Cialis.com and find out what the Cialis Promise Program can mean for you. It's an offer you won't want to miss. Are you ready?
Start the new year.
Of all people, you pick that tired piece of Edie.
With new housewives.
You have the hots for Annie.
And new dirt.
Martha's missing.
They found the body.
And all new Desperate Housewives. Sunday 9, 8 Central only on ABC.
Sunday morning, join the hardest working pregame show on television as Chris Berman and the gang get you ready for all the day's action on NFL Countdown at 11 a.m. Eastern. Then after the games at 10 Eastern, NFL primetime with all the highlights from the first round of the playoffs. A full day of NFL coverage Sunday on ESPN. Sean Alexander has a left wrist injury. His return is questionable. They are seeing if he can grip a football and hang on to it. The other injury of note, Jackson, who splits time with Marshall Faulk for the Rams, has bruised ribs. His return is questionable.
So here's what happens for the Seattle Seahawks. You get Maurice Morris, who is just in his third year, if Sean can't play. And if you're the Rams, if Steven Jackson can't go, you get Marshall Faulk in a more full-time role.
Let's see, the edge would be...
Yeah, I think so.
Seattle.
Yeah, you would think that.
The younger guy.
On the previous play, due to the fight, we stopped the game clock. After a game clock stoppage, we must reset the play clock to 25 seconds, which did not happen. We will give Seattle their timeout back.
Oh, isn't that nice? Now that's generous.
It's Christmas, right? It's Christmassy.
All right, there's Sean Alexander. And I'll tell you what, you got another hand to carry the ball in. He's going to be in. This is it.
What do you know?
This is it, man. Unless you physically can't walk on this field.
What do you know about carrying the ball?
Are you kidding?
Third down for Hasselbeck. Four-man rush. Over the middle. Tipped up in the air and picked off again. Intercepted by DeJuan Gross. There is a flag down in the secondary. That looked like a face mask on Tommy Polley.
I'll tell you, this is a clothesline because he hits Morris right in the mouth and in the helmet. This is arm to helmet. And they're gonna not only are they gonna get the ball there, it's gonna be a 15-yard penalty.
Does it happen before the interception or after? There's the question. Does
it happen before the interception? That's how the ball ended up back up in the air.
It was intended for Morris.
All right, take a look at it here. Here comes the ball in the air. Boom, Polley hits him right there. There's no interception yet, and that's a face mask. The ball was still live.
Personal foul, grasping the face mask, number 57 of the defense, while the pass was in the air. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot and a first down.
They're calling it on Trev Faulk. and not 52 Tommy Polly. And it's a huge call because it's a first down for the Seahawks.
And it would have been a first down for the Rams with the second interception of the game.
Yeah, this was an outstanding, well, I mean, it was kind of an easy call to make. And here comes Sean Alexander. Here's the play. Just take a look at, watch this, across the mouth. And that ball is still being tipped up in the air. So the infraction is right here by Falk.
Now you've got a guy who's caught 9 passes all year trying to go in a playoff game and step up. A lot to ask.
Alexander is back in on 1st and 10. Hasselbeck steps up, throws underneath Ingram, touchdown.
Bobby Ingram is a difference maker for this football team because he is Matt Hasselbeck's favorite, really his favorite target. This guy missed some games, and when he was out, they had some problems. When Bobby Ingram's in the game, it makes a big difference. Number 84 is Bobby Ingram coming across. Look at this. That is just a perfect pass and the great catch.
Bobby Ingram had some really good years in Chicago. After he tore up a knee, they thought he was done there. But Bobby Ingram can still play the game and made a huge play right there for a 19-yard touchdown catch in the playoffs.
Every great story starts with a great adventure. Introducing the all-new Nissan Pathfinder, the 270-horsepower engine, 3-row seating for 7, refined interior with GPS navigation and DVD entertainment, and more off-road capability than ever before. Because you can't talk about the mountaintop unless you actually see the mountaintop. Tell better stories in the new 7-passenger, 270-horsepower Nissan Pathfinder.
In 2 days in New York City, America's favorite bachelorette begins her search for love in a 2-hour premiere event.
New York is a great place to be and explore. The perfect city to fall in love.
Jenna is the all-American girl.
She's cute and sexy all at once.
Well, she's as cool as she is hot.
Yeah, I'll fall in love with that girl.
I've been flirting with you since the second I saw you.
The chemistry was really picking up.
He loves me.
This will definitely be the wildest ride of my life.
All of us vying for the same girl. Game on.
I had no idea how competitive these guys were. I have sent half of you guys home.
This has become personal.
I will chew him up like a piece of garbage.
Somebody's gonna get arrested.
It's so hard to date all of these men at once, knowing ultimately you only want to be with one.
This is the most difficult thing I've ever had to do, but I'm willing to do it in order to find the man I'm supposed to spend the rest of my life with.
The Bachelorette premieres with a special 2-hour event Monday at 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
ABC's coverage of the NFL playoffs brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 39. Nissan, everything we touch, we shift, and everything we shift, we try and make better. Bud Light, fresh, smooth, real, it's all here. And Cialis, ask your doctor if a free sample of Cialis is right for you. Today's aerial coverage is provided by Anheuser-Busch. Qwest Field in Seattle, where the Seahawks are back into the ballgame, courtesy of Bobby Engram's 19-yard touchdown catch. Low line drive kick. Avion Kayson from the 1. And take it out at the 17. Timeout with 8:14 to go, first half. Back in a moment.
A shift has been made. And the full-size truck party finally got interesting. A shift has been made. And the mid-size truck feels a whole lot bigger. A shift has been made. And when you think tough, powerful, innovative trucks, think Nissan.
Hey, I see.
all the time. I think you're a little bit of mine, waiting to give me a line. Give me a line, give me a love. Give me a taste. Oh, yeah, that's right, you're gonna have to chase me.
Back in Seattle with two head coaches, both of whom believe in the pass, but in widely differing varieties of passing attack. Mike Martz was the offensive coordinator for Dick Vermeil when the Rams won a Super Bowl. Mike Holmgren won his Super Bowl in Seattle. It's West Coast versus vertical.
Don't you love just talking to both of them, though? I mean, they're almost opposites. But when you sit, Martz is sitting there with that little smile on his face, you know he's got something up his sleeve.
They're almost to the point of eccentrics when it comes to their offensive philosophies. They believe in it so much.
Steven Jackson is back in for the Rams, goes to the slot in the near side. So they have five wide receivers. Four-man rush for Seattle. Bulger underneath, Curtis to the 31-yard line. That will be enough for a first down. And Kudavides, the middle linebacker, had to make the tackle on Kevin Curtis, the wide receiver.
When they split them out like that, now you've got four defensive linemen on five people. They don't have a chance, the defensive line.
Marc Bulger just slides around a little bit. Kevin Curtis, they really went looking for somebody to take Oz Akeem's spot when he left for Detroit a few years ago. And Kevin Curtis has seemed to have been the one to step up and fill that third receiver role.
Said that Mike Holmgren won his Super Bowl in Seattle. Obviously, it was in Green Bay. Bulger behind Isaac Bruce and nearly picked off on the tip by Kaz Zavinsky.
Isaac is saying, hey, Marcus Truefont is, you know, pushing me around. That's what Ray Rhodes wants, the defensive coordinator of Seattle. He doesn't want his young corners to sit back there and say, oh, boy, that's Torrey Holt. Ooh, Isaac Bruce, I can't touch him. No, he said, go after him.
I'm moving down here by you, Mike.
Would they really make those noises,
yeah.
Joe?
Well, you know. Maybe.
That's scary.
Maybe. See? I told you.
You got to lay off the coffee, man.
Second and 10. Blitz coming. They pick it up. Bulger with a lot of time. Now he's pressured and throws it away.
There's a flag on the play, and it's going to be holding. There's another flag downfield also at the 40-yard line. And that in that area,
that's holding.
That's right. And at the line of scrimmage, that's holding the other way.
I don't think this play is ever going to happen.
I tell you what's amazing is just to sit there and watch Bulger sit in that pocket and really not move. And he doesn't, you know, he doesn't care.
We have fouls on both teams. Illegal contact, 94, defense. We have a personal foul, chop block on the offense. Those penalties offset. Repeat second down.
Now you want to see a rule change, a chop block where you can eliminate a guy forever in the game against a holding penalty. And I'm going to tell you what.
I do believe the competition committee will take some time to look at the way the defensive linemen have been taken out over this year. Definitely something that I'm sure they'll consider. But right now, the bigger challenge is really lies for these corners for the Seattle Seahawks. They're getting physical, but you don't want to miss Torrey Holt or Isaac Bruce or Kevin Curtis going down the field.
So basically, that was no play at all. Second and 10 all over again. Jackson out in the flat, took his eyes off of it and dropped it. He saw Kaz Zavinsky about the same time he saw the football.
If Kaz Zavinsky has two good elbows, remember, he went out earlier and was hurt. Now this one's wrapped up really tight. I don't think he ever really focuses on the ball. He's trying to make the tackle, and you see him not make the catch.
This Seattle crowd has not seen a playoff victory since 1984. Talk about hungry. These people are starving to death.
And listen to them. I mean, it's unbelievable.
3-man rush, and Bulger fits it into Isaac Bruce to the Seattle 49. A perfect throw and a gain of 22.
Boy, I'll tell you, you want to talk about a perfect throw. He throws this thing over two defenders in two different positions. Look down the middle of the field and to the right. Watch this. There goes one, there goes the other one. Two defenders go up in the air, and this ball was thrown in perfectly.
You can drop nine, and he's going to get it in and rush two. The thing you can't do with Marc Bulger is give him time to throw the football. You've got to pressure him. Paul, you keep mentioning it. It's something they're going to have to do.
They're not getting there with four.
Double pump, tries to run, got back near the line of scrimmage.
Marc Bulger has been on fire in this first half against the Seattle defense. Young man out of West Virginia does a real nice job of throwing different types of passes. What he does is he arcs it, and then when he gets an opportunity in the middle of the football field, he guns it. He sees the field so well that he is able to judge whether he wants to put trajectory on it or he wants to try and fire it in. Two completions, four attempts for 9 yards. Look at the completions over 10 yards. 6 of 8.
Here they come.
They've already gotten to him three times. Bulger throws this one out of bounds. McDonald was the closest man to it. It will be 3rd and 11.
Well, I'll tell you, this shows you what happens when you put the blitz on Bulger. He first thing he sees when he sees the blitz, so watch him move to his left. Here comes the blitz. He knows he's got to get out. So when he moves out, the only thing he can do now is just throw the ball away. This is what I don't care. You got to put these guys at corners and safeties on islands, and you've got to send seven people.
And Tom Newton is starting left guard, who already had a bad knee, came up limping after that play, and the Rams don't have much wiggle room in the offensive line. Another blitz. Bulger sidesteps and throws, complete. Holt. Holt inside the 40, dives and should have the first down. Boy, did he know where those sticks were.
See, I don't care that they complete this pass here. They made Bulger step up. This was Torrey Holt coming back. But watch what Bulger does here. He sees blitz coming. They send the ball. He just steps up. And the guy that really makes this play is number 81, Torrey Holt. Watch him come back to him. Come back, come back, come back. Oh, I got the ball. And then he goes back and picks up the first down.
Well, they brought out the chains to measure.
He's got it.
And they do have it. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to question you and your ability to see the difference in 2 inches from here.
I'm moving back over by Joe.
Different, two guys made great plays on that route. Marc Bulger with the pressure, sliding around, staying with the route, and then you saw the awareness of Torrey Holt. This is a guy that has football awareness, knows where he has to get to. First he catches the ball, then he works to get to first down.
First down just inside the Seahawks 39. Marshall fought. Nowhere to go, grinds out a couple. Let's check in with Susie.
Well, I talked to him before the game. He told me this is a season of transition from being the guy to sharing time with Steven Jackson to then Jackson getting the bulk of the load. He said the key now is just being ready to produce when he's called upon and guiding Steven without overstepping his bounds or overloading the rookie. He said he is always deeply involved in the offense, whether he's on the field or not. His approach will never change. Even if he was third string, he said, that's just what's inside of him.
And Susie, you know the reason he's involved. He is so smart. He understands this offense as well as anybody. Blitz coming. They throw it out to Goodspeed, and now an official waves it off incomplete. Goodspeed was all the way out as a flanker back. Marshall Faulk is third behind Jim Brown and Barry Sanders in yards from scrimmage per game and ahead of Walter Payton. at his remarkable company, and that's because he was widely regarded as one of the best receivers, not just running backs, receivers in this game.
He's also so smart. He knows more about this offense than anybody else does, except Mike Martz.
Bulger with a man in his face. Bruce thought he was hit early, and no flag.
And that is what the Seattle Seahawks are going to have to do defensively. They're going to have to let Trufant and Lucas, as the corners, step up and make plays. Marcus Trufant, in my opinion, is real close to being a Pro Bowler. Had 5 interceptions this year. As a matter of fact, every one of their secondary people had more than 4, the 2 safeties and the corners. But Marcus Trufant has got those really quick feet and great hips.
It's a very young, very talented secondary and a lot of top draft choices back there. Kevin Stemke, talk about a guy who doesn't get used much. The punter on the Rams hangs this one high down to the 14-yard line. 23-yard kick, but no return. Let's go back to Susie.
Well, Mike, a shootout was what we were looking for in the first wild card matchup of the weekend. The last possession for Seattle looked like disaster. Another interception, but no, it was a face mask. First down, it allowed Hasselbeck to hit Bobby Engram for the touchdown. He calls Engram the most underrated on his receiving core. And Engram told me before the game, he likes flying under the radar. That's his personality, not too flashy. He hears it from the right people, players, coaches. They tell him he's an old school guy, dependable, runs great routes.
Well, Susie, would this be a huge drive for Seattle right now? 4:17 to go in the half, starting deep in their own territory. If they get anything out of this, even a field goal would be enormous.
We still don't know how Sean Alexander is going to react because he hasn't touched the ball since he's gone back in since the wrist got hurt.
Alexander crossing the 20 to about the 23. First playoff game of the postseason, Rams at Seattle from Qwest Field. 67,000 on hand, hoping that the Seahawks can do something they haven't done since 1984. The Rams won both home and away, including a dramatic comeback in the game here.
I think Sean Alexander's okay.
Looks fine, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
I want to make a point.
He had 2 wrists.
No, I want to make a point here. Sean Alexander is going to have to become a right-handed carrier of the football. I don't believe that he's going to be able to switch it over to the left side. He likes to run left behind Steve Hutchinson and Walter Jones, but he's going to have that ball exposed to the defense coming at him. This is the thing. Watch where he puts the ball. Remember, he hurt his left wrist. He's running left, and he's still got it in his right hand. Now, there are some guys in the league like Emmitt Smith that do that. He doesn't. He's a hand switcher, so it'd be interesting.
And Morris comes in his place. Morris underneath and drops the little check down. Looking up to see who was coming, it appeared.
Tommy Pauley was coming, the linebacker. And I tell you, you know, it for someone that's really not used to doing this, to catching the ball, and Joe mentioned it, you know, you got Morris that comes into a ball game and they, you know, they really don't play him a whole lot. And then you put him out there, he's going to peak a little bit.
You know what, though, you expect, I was looking at it this way. If you're dressed and you have to go out and play, I don't care how many years you've been in this league, you better know what you're doing.
Well, he only had 30 carries all year compared to Sean Alexander's 353. Hasselbeck underneath. Gain of about 8 to tackle by Thomas on the tight end.
That's Corin Robinson.
Or check it on Corin Robinson.
And that's a guy that they really need to step up. Corin Robinson, he gives them speed, he gives them toughness, and even more importantly than just catching the football, he gives them the ability to block outside, which is so important to Sean Alexander's 16, almost 1,700 yards.
He had a breakout year 2 seasons ago, 78 catches for 1,240 yards. Then his numbers fell off last year. And further still this year because of the various suspensions. 4-man rush, Hasselbeck, the pocket collapsed, and Archuleta nearly had the interception on the pass intended for Mealy, and Ryan Pickett just broke down the pocket.
Matt Hasselbeck does a real good job of staying home. Here comes the pressure, hanging in the pocket, and then he gets buried. Now, this, you're seeing a little bit of a philosophical change by Mike Holmgren. That was third and two. If Sean Alexander is in this game and healthy, I believe he runs it to try and pick it up. There he was forced to throw.
Ken Walter to kick to Sean McDonald. McDonald from the 18, dancing, and doesn't get very far. Robbie Tobeck is wired for sound. Here's what he hears in the trenches.
Jam, jam, jam! Jam, jam! Keep blocking as long as it takes now. Hey, as long as it takes, hold them out.
You know, I had a long conversation with him the other day, and he is really a funny guy. But I'll tell you one thing, he said he loves to play this game. And Hasselbeck was talking about it. When that quarterback sneaker that won the game the other day against Atlanta, he said, don't go running over me. The guy in front of me is really too big. I can't block him. But that's exactly where they went.
Bulger goes to the shotgun. As we approach the two-minute warning, this pass too high and incomplete. Richard with a coverage on McDonald. We've reached the two-minute warning officially at 1:57. Back to Seattle after this.
If a moonlit moment turns into the right moment, will you be ready? You can be with Cialis. Cialis is the only erectile dysfunction tablet clinically proven to both work fast and work up to 36 hours. 36 hours to relax and take your time. 36 hours to choose the moment that's right for you and your partner. Cialis is only for men healthy enough for sexual activity. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain or certain alpha blockers for prostate problems or high blood pressure, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. Erections lasting longer than 4 hours, though rare, require immediate medical help. Discuss your health status with your doctor and ask if Cialis is right for you. 36 hours Cialis. When the moment is right, will you be ready?
Hi, I'd like to redeem my credit card miles someplace warm.
No.
But I'm in Chicago. It's freezing.
Ooh, I predict a no storm.
Can my miles get me to Mexico?
No way, Jose.
St. Thomas?
Saint happening.
Hawaii?
Anoha.
Cabo.
Cab no, maybe.
L.A.?
N.O.
Who's in charge over there?
That would be our C.E.N.O.
Go from no to no hassle with Capital One No Hassle Rewards. There's no blackout dates on any airline anytime.
Nine.
What?
Niet.
But
no.
I'm calling Capital One.
Nunca. What's in your wallet?
The survivors of Flight 815 are all running from something. And this Wednesday, there's no escape. At All New Lost, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central, followed by an all-new Alias, only on ABC.
Coming up on the Lexus Halftime Show, Chris Berman, Steve Young, Michael Strahan, and Brian Billick take a look at the San Diego Chargers' turnaround year. And boy, haven't they ever under Marty Schottenheimer and Drew Brees.
Got a lineman, a quarterback, a defensive lineman, and a coach. I love you, Boomer, but you're still a lineman.
Second and 10 for the Rams, who only have one timeout remaining.
Go get him. You better go get him.
Four-man rush and the toss to Falk. And Marshall Falk will get out of bounds at the 25 after a gain of only three. It'll be third and seven.
Give you an idea of the philosophies of both of these coaches. St. Louis, they have 9 completions for 187 yards. That's Mike Martz. Seattle has 9 completions for 97 yards. And that's Mike Holmgren.
Well, and you know, when you look at it, though, you're looking at it, guys, here's a team that goes downfield against a team that really doesn't. I mean, their whole game, Seattle's within 15 yards of the line of scrimmage. Oh, man.
And Bulger taken down at the 15-yard line. They got the pressure they needed straight up the middle that time by Chike O'Keefer.
Well, I'll tell you, O'Keefer, watch what he does. 56. This is a stunt with the end of the tackle.
Illegal use of hands in the face. 21 defense.
Oh,
5-yard penalty.
Oh,
automatic. First down.
That is huge. Instead of the sack, you've got a first down.
Yeah, it's Kenny Lucas, number 21, hands to the face. But I'll tell you what a just an outstanding play. Here comes a penalty. Lucas, now, there it is. His hands, he hit him in the helmet with his hands. So they call that. Okay? Now, look at this. O'Keefer coming up the middle. Look at that play. They didn't see the stunt coming. It was the first time in this game they had this stunt, and it absolutely worked.
And here's the thing that Mike Holmgren has to ask himself. Is my team mature enough to overcome a play like that? They've really got to hunker down now and play really tough defense after giving up an opportunity.
And this is a Seattle team that has committed the fewest penalties in the NFL. Intended for Curtis. Bruce was also in the area, incomplete with 1:40 to go in the half.
They had a whole lot of guys in that area and a lot of green shirts, too.
Take into consideration, look at the division Seattle plays in. I mean, St. Louis is really the only team that lines up people and runs them down the field. You got San Francisco and Arizona in this division. So, I mean, and these young corners have got to be smart with what they do. So they don't get to, I think, play a lot of foolish football. Plus, Mike Holmgren does a great job of emphasizing it to his ball club regarding penalties.
Bulger, after that great start, has hit only one of his last six. But that will not stop them from putting it up again. More flags. And this looked like early movement on the Rams.
Prior to the snap, false start, 83, offense, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
But guys, Kevin Curtis, the second-year man out of Utah State.
It doesn't matter to them. Second down and 15 is so what? I mean, that's your minimum route in this offense is 15 yards. I think the big thing here will be how Ray Rhodes, the defensive coordinator of the Seahawks, decides to play this down. If he plays zone, he's going to give Bulger a chance to pick up a big chunk. If he goes after him, he'll have to get it out of his hands quicker.
Boy, they look like they're having problems on defense lining up.
Second and 15, draw to Falk. That time he appeared to run right into the heart of the defense. Chad Brown, number 94, led the charge.
You know, a team that really, in a game like this, if they know they're not going to run the ball very much, it's hard to block anybody.
And Seattle has stopped the clock at the 1:32. Mark, let's go to Susie.
Well, the Rams were looking for the three-game sweep, and they opened with big game, as in Torrey Holt. Marc Bulger perfect on the opening possession that ends in a touchdown. Marshall Faulk says he loves the playoffs because there's nothing to do but win. He practically walks in for their second score. But Matt Hasselbeck, keeping the Seahawks alive, hits the veteran Bobby Engram for the touchdown. 14-10 Rams. Seattle looking for their first playoff win in 20 years.
All right, Suze, a minute 32 to go first half. You know, we were showing you Chad Brown, who made that last play. And when we first met Chad Brown when he was with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and all you have to know about him, you go to proexotics.com and you find out the guy raises snakes and lizards and yuck.
I don't even shake hands with him, you know that?
No.
I do not like snakes and lizards. I don't shake hands with him because he touches them.
You're terrible.
Bulger pressure, trying to run for it, taken down at the 31. And they'll have to punt.
Chad Brown, they really have missed his pass rushing ability when he was hurt.
Look,
coming back
down
after a broken leg.
Joe, he is down on the line of scrimmage, and he's going up against a tight end, Manamaliuna, and the tight end really can't keep him out. Now, you see Orlando Pace come back and pick him up on the backside, but just the fact that he was there, he's the one that forced Bulger to step it up inside. I thought if Bulger would have kept to the outside, he might have been able to pick up more yardage.
And Brown very slow to come off the field. Seattle has burned its last time out. Kevin Stemke is on to punt. And the crowd is really psyched here in Seattle.
Yeah,
Line drive kick to Bobby Engram. From the 29, got a couple of blocks. Flag is down. Engram stopped at the 39. An 11-yard return after a punt of 40. Now Walt Coleman will check the penalty.
I tell you what, that flag was thrown as soon as Bobby Engram caught the ball. There was an illegal block in the back.
During the return, illegal block in the back, 27 of the return team, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Jordan Babineau, a backup defensive back, called for the penalty. Coming up, hope you'll join Al Michaels and John Madden for the second half of our Wild Card Saturday doubleheader. The NFL's top rusher, Curtis Martin, will lead the Jets against Drew Brees, LaDainian Tomlinson, and the AFC West champion Chargers. That's next here on ABC. And Drew Brees, the NFL's comeback player of the year, is selected by the Associated.
You have to wonder, looking at the weather conditions out in San Diego, it has been raining relentlessly out there. I wonder what the field's going to be like and how that will affect those great running backs, as well as, you know, the job that Drew's done.
Hasselbeck to throw, goes over the middle of Tula Mealy up to the 44-yard line with a clock running, a gain of 17.
You know, you can still go in the middle. This is the time in a two-minute drill, in the first minute and 10 seconds of this drill, go to the middle of the field, because mostly they leave it open where there are only linebackers there. You've got a chance to throw one more in the middle.
Hasselbeck dives. The clock will continue to run. No timeouts.
Now get up and spike the ball. Get everybody on the line and just spike the ball. Just spike it real quick. There you go. 29
seconds.
Stop
it with 29 seconds left.
I like the way he runs this two-minute drill. It's not crazy. It's not out of control. He's got everybody lining up quickly. One of the things that I tried to do in a two-minute drill was, when I called routes, make sure that the receivers are on the same side of the field if you're going to call a couple of plays. So when they have to come back, they don't have to run all the way across the field, waste 3 or 4 seconds.
The numbers on Hasselbeck. That was a big run, 9 yards, but it brings up a third and one. And they'll try to get the first down and do with Morris, but with no timeouts, now you've got to try to spike it again. And they did, with 19 seconds left.
You know, they ran a draw play, and it's exactly what you were talking about. They ran a draw play, and everybody got back. It only took them 10 seconds.
It's because they practiced it over and over. They are very good at that.
I tell you, it really is. It's smart football. They have, and with 19 seconds, he can throw at least 3 more passes to the outside.
But he'll probably throw at least one in the middle and then spike it again and kick the field goal. But that's the efficiency of a quarterback that's doing a good job.
Brown has a very strong leg. Hasselbeck under pressure. Down the middle and incomplete with 14 seconds left.
Well, they just grabbed Hasselbeck, and so he realized he had no one open, and he had to fire the ball down the field. Now, 5 seconds went off the clock.
Now you have to be careful if you throw the ball in the middle of the football field. If you throw a 15-yard completion, you've got to figure it's going to be running down under 9 seconds. I don't believe you can do that. They're going to have to work the ball, in this case, Paul, to the sidelines to give themselves a chance to be able to kick a field goal.
And look at the defensive back sitting on the outside. They're sitting on the out routes.
Hasselbeck throws into triple coverage intended for Engram. Clock stopped with 9 seconds to go.
I tell you what, well, he was going for everything.
Well, there's no wind factor at all in this stadium. I mean, the flags on the goalposts are hanging completely down. And on fourth down, they're still going to try and get some more yards. Now, Josh Brown has. His 53 was the longest, and he's 1 for 1 this year from over 50 yards.
Well, this would have been 61. He kicked a 61-yarder in high school. That was off a tee. And now Hasselbeck trying to wind up so he can throw it deep, and is taken down by Lewis at the 44 with 1 second on the clock.
shot.
Now the Rams will have a shot.
See, now here's a situation where if you're Matt Hasselbeck, you've got to get this ball out of your hands. It was fourth down. On the crazy chance, and of course this is professional football and crazy things happen, now all of a sudden you're going to give those Ram receivers a chance to run down the field, Marc Bulger throw it up in the air. What can happen? Interference, face mask, a lot of bad things can happen to Seahawks. Touchdowns, yeah.
The only thing the Rams don't have out there are starting blocks.
That's right.
These guys are heading downfield. And look at the Seahawks. They're going to put three guys at the five-yard line and wait. We'll be here when you get here.
Bulger throws this one for Curtis. And that's the kind of play they're hoping for, a penalty so they can get another play. Our score here in Seattle, the Rams 14, the Seahawks 10. Stay tuned for the Lexus Halftime Show with Chris Berman, Steve Young, Michael Strahan, and Brian Billick after this from the NFL and a word from our ABC station.
On the clock at the United Way draft is... We're just getting word of a trade.
A high-ranking camper at the camping club has just confirmed they have traded up into this slot.
We select Marshall Faulk.
There has to be a bunch of happy campers in St. Louis with this pick. Falk's got a rare ability to lead, which you definitely need out there in the woods.
That way.
Looks like Faulk is ready to report for camp.
Get involved in your community. It's what matters.
There's an easier way to get the gear the pros wear. Just call 877-NFL-SHOP. For a free team catalog, go to NFL-SHOP on NFL.com or call 877-NFL-SHOP.
Sunday, a widow and her family watch their dreams go up in smoke.
Roseanne and her daughter were basically homeless.
Now our team is off to a remote destination for their most extreme mission yet. An all-new Extreme Makeover Home Edition. Then on Monday, discover how they made it all happen.
We're going to show you everything, how we really got it all done. Don't
stop. You've seen the before, you've seen the after. Now see everything in between. Sunday, an all-new Extreme Makeover Home Edition. Then Monday, it's the premiere of How'd They Do That? Only on ABC.
Hey, Jimbo! Good luck on those SATs. If he goes Ivy League, we're toast.
Get control of your finances with CityPro. From savings to paying for college. Come in for your free financial game plan today.
What's that?
Oh, it's a duvet cover.
A what?
A duvet cover. It's a decorative sham that also protects. Watch the game. The double quarter pounder with cheese. Pound one. Oh!
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. What? It's a throw pillow.
Jets fans, ready for some football? Jets versus Chargers tonight at 8.
The Lexus Halftime Show. Brought to you by Lexus and their passionate pursuit of perfection. Here now, Chris Berman.
And welcome back, everybody, to our Lexus Halftime Show. 14-10, St. Louis leads Seattle. And Chris Berman, along with Steve Young, Michael Strahan, Brian Billiken, kind of settling in after that original flurry by the St. Louis Rams. I think back last year, Marc Bulger in the playoffs against Carolina, Steve, when Mike Martz wouldn't let him throw to the end zone with the game on the line, they ended up losing in double overtime. This is a different guy. Confidence and on the road.
He obviously trusts him very much more than last year. And in the playoffs, you can define yourself, and he's doing a great job. He has been accurate all day long. He came out hot. Here's the big play to Curtis to set up the touchdown. He's been hot long. He's been accurate short. He's been touch passes over the middle. I tell you, he stays this hot, he's going to get him at the end of the game.
He should be hot. They're not coming near the guy.
The defensive lineman, you hate it. You have to get pass rush. You have to make the quarterback throw the ball quick. The dropping Chad Brown, the best rusher, you got to send him. Don't drop him. He's no use if you're in coverage. Send him. Rush him. If four's not getting it done, send five. If it's not five, send six. Make Marc Bulger throw the ball quick.
Well, I think they see a little bit of that. The last couple of series, they did put a little bit more pressure on them, and Seattle looked a lot more aggressive, a lot more comfortable the latter part of that half than the earlier part. I'm impressed the way both teams are responding to the challenges. They both recognize that they're in a real game.
Well, they know each other pretty well, and we're going to see what happens the last 30 minutes because the Rams trying to become the first ever 8-8 team to win a playoff game. More in a moment.
Coming up on the Lexus Halftime Show, how San Diego has turned it around and charged into the playoffs.
At Lexus, we developed an air purification system that uses ultraviolet technology and micron filters to help eliminate any odors and airborne irritants from the cabin, even pollen. Because we don't want anything, no matter how small, to spoil your drive.
Feeling desperate?
Of all people, you pick that tired piece of eating.
For an all-new Housewives.
You're dating my wife.
I thought you said you were separated.
This Sunday.
You want me back?
The number one new show returns.
I am a professional model.
Can you swing a sword?
With new secrets.
You didn't tell him about
your adultery? No.
New guilty pleasures.
You have the hots for our name.
And new dirt.
What is missing? We don't know if she's dead.
They found the body.
An all-new Desperate Housewives. Sunday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Welcome back to the Lexus Halftime Show. Chad Pennington, Jets arriving earlier in San Diego. That's our second game, Jets at Chargers. For a preview in San Diego, here's Al Michaels. Al?
Chris, thank you very much. And I think when the Chargers put together their highlight film for this season, they can title it Reversal of Fortune. Last year, they stumbled out of the gate, never recovered, finished 4-12, and were last in the AFC West. And then there was really nothing to portend any great turnaround in the offseason. But, well, Michelle Tafoya has the rest of the story.
With the first choice in the 2004 NFL draft, the San Diego Chargers select Eli Manning.
The draft was an interesting time for this franchise. The Manning family said, there's one team we don't want to go to, and that's San Diego. How did that strike you?
We talked to the Manning family three different occasions, and we're told each and every time that we want no part of your organization. That was very upsetting. It was an embarrassment to the organization. So we made a plan, moved forward, and everybody went on with their lives.
That plan was to trade Manning to the Giants for Philip Rivers, who was tapped to be the future of the Chargers franchise. But fourth-year veteran Drew Brees, who had struggled over the past three seasons, was not ready to give up his post.
I can't control who they bring in here. I set my individual goals, and not one of those goals going into training camp was just to be the starting quarterback of the San Diego Chargers, because in my mind, I already was.
So what did turn Drew Brees into the player he's become?
Drew had said, Coach, I would like to meet with this squad before you do, to assume this leadership role, knowing full well that 50% or more of those people that are listening to you may be saying to one another, what is this guy talking about? He's not even going to be playing for us. My whole intent for calling that meeting was just to create that belief that, hey, you know, we can do it.
With a vastly improved performance this season, Brees has been the catalyst for a team that went 4-12 just a year ago. With help from new faces on both sides of the ball, the man who came this close to losing his job has breathed new life into the Chargers.
It's totally different from last year, I tell you. So all you other people out there that think the Chargers don't want to win, you're wrong. Plain and simple.
What kind of satisfaction have you derived from all of this?
We're not the laughing stock. We're not picking first in the draft. We're a darn good football team, and we're proud of it.
At 12-4, the Chargers find themselves in unfamiliar territory, the playoffs, a place they haven't been in almost a decade.
Once again, no one is expecting us to do anything in the playoffs, but that's fine. We think we're going to shock a lot of people.
As I told our football team this morning, Michelle, I said, what we're going to do, our goal, our objective, is to win four games, one at a time.
Michelle, thank you. Marty Schottenheimer announced today, AP Coach of the Year. Congratulations, Jim. That's the late game. Guys, adjustments. You're at halftime. You've done this a million times. Brian, what are you telling your team?
Seattle's got to get St. Louis off the field on third down. They've given up too many third and long situations.
If Seattle doesn't change their pass rush strategy, they're not going to win the game. They can't keep up with the Rams.
But if Seattle's receivers will catch the ball and not look so surprised every time that Matt throws them the ball, if they have zero drops today, I mean the second half, I think they win.
Well, we saw in the regular season in October, it was the Rams that came from 17 down against the Seahawks. Can the Seahawks come from 11 down against the Rams? Turnabout fair play. It's playoff time. See you after the game.
All cars have headlights to illuminate the road ahead. But Lexus has developed a headlight that actually rotates up to 15 degrees. To reveal what's around the bend before you get to the bend. What kind of a difference can 15 degrees make? A very noticeable one.
The Lexus Halftime Show, brought to you by Lexus and their passionate pursuit of perfection. We'll be back with the second half kickoff after this from our ABC station.
The Bachelorette takes on the Big Apple, a two-hour premiere, Monday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC. It's the one moment every father dreads.
I was in Carmen's room and I found some mints.
So how many did you take?
I ate five, Monday through Friday.
You're on the pill!
So is Max!
All new George Lopez, Tuesday, 8, 30, 7, 30 Central, only on ABC.
The Mercury Mountaineer, featuring advanced track with roll stability control, four-wheel independent suspension, and all-wheel drive. Plus, comfortable room for up to seven. Now get a 2005 Mercury Mountaineer convenience all-wheel drive for $314 a month with a no-charge DVD entertainment system. See your Tri-State Lincoln Mercury dealer today. Of the Bahamas. Call 1-800-BAHAMAS or visit Bahamas.com.
A shift has been made, and better stories will be told. And hardcore just got harder. Core. And taking 8 camping is only a problem for the tent. And the concrete jungle is finally tamed. A shift has been made. And when you think adventure, on road or off, think Nisa.
Watch Bill Ritter only on Eyewitness News.
The Rams got off to such a fast start here in the first game of the playoffs, but Seattle, to its credit, has turned around and cut the lead to 14-10. And the Seahawks will get the ball first to start the second half.
I don't think the weathermen hit this right on the button, do you?
It was supposed to be snow and rain or whatever.
And they missed by about 10 degrees, thank goodness.
And if you're St. Louis, you just have to be thrilled with the way the weather turned out.
Morris and Evans are deep for the Seattle Seahawks. Morris from the 5. And cut down to 24.
Talked about the fast start St. Louis got off to. I mean, it looked like they could have turned this ugly in a hurry.
They really could because they're that explosive on offense. I think in this half what they have to do is go back to working the middle of the football field and create problems for Michael Bulger, their rookie safety, who was a converted linebacker.
And I think Seattle, if they don't put pressure on the quarterback, on Marc Bulger, they're not going to get anything done. They were successful doing that. Offensively, Sean Alexander's got to get in this ball game. If he gets in a ball game and he gets 100 yards, they're going to win the game.
Hasselbeck, short set, goes out to Stevens. And the big tight end down the sideline to the 45. Let's go to Susie.
Spoke to both coaches at halftime. Mike Martz, not so concerned about all the pressure Marc Bulger was seeing before the half. He said, Marc will make the adjustments now, and you'll see more of a regular mix. And they expect the secondary to back up a little bit, probably give them a little bit more room. As for Mike Holmgren, he was surprised that given the interceptions and the tipped balls, that his team was still in it. He said they just have to improve on field position.
All right, Susie. And, of course, that's a big battle for them. Because as we pointed out before, this is not your typical big play offense. The West Coast usually has its own version of grind it out.
What really kills it is when receivers drop balls. That's the thing that really sets this offense back. If you're only going to throw 6 and 7 yard routes, then you've got to be able to complete those passes.
We've got an injury timeout. The starting right guard Chris Gray is down for the Seahawks.
You left Rusty alone in your apartment?
It's okay. I got him one of those shock collars.
Oh, that's so cruel.
No. It's part of his training.
Can I get you a Bud Light? My roommate's got some in the fridge.
Thanks, Rusty.
Cool.
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light.
So what's up? You want to hang in or you want to go?
It's all here.
Velocity meets versatility. The all-new Hemi-powered Dodge Magnum. Open it up from either end. Dodge Magnum with 5-star, the highest frontal crash test rating.
The survivors of Flight 815 are all running from something. And this Wednesday, there's no escape. At all-new Lost, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central, followed by an all-new Alias, only on ABC.
ABC's coverage of the NFL playoffs brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dr. Pepper, your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper, one taste and you get it. Autotrader.com, sell your car fast on the ultimate automotive classified site. And Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 39. And today's aerial coverage provided by Anheuser-Busch.
That's a pretty stadium, isn't it?
Really beautiful. Paul Allen, the owner of the Seahawks, did a wonderful job. Wanted an outdoor stadium. Got a great one.
Hasselbeck quickly underneath Jackson. Nice move to get free. First down at the Rams 47.
Boy, does Matt Hasselbeck know this offense. Darryl Jackson all of a sudden is in this game. We saw him drop the first pass to him. It looked like the first two series his head wasn't in it. Now all of a sudden he sees the blitz adjustment, makes the move, and gets away from three Rams before two get to him. Boy, that's you talk about a confidence builder for a quarterback and a wide receiver.
Seattle moving the ball crisply to start the third quarter. Hasselbeck again underneath to Atula Mealy, incomplete. First half numbers, 224 total yards for the Rams, who usually win the statistical battle. Right now they're winning the battle on the scoreboard as well. Rushing yards, 71 for the Seahawks. They'll probably need more domination than that. And Chris Gray being taken to the locker room on the cart. That is not good news along their offensive line. Get a report on him as soon as possible. Alexander injured a left wrist in the first half. Taken down by Anthony Hargrove, who not only played off the blocker and strung out the play, he made the tackle.
Yeah, well, take a look at who he beats. Walter Jones, number 71, who's the tackle. This guy just, look at this. Look at this play he makes. He not only beats Walter Jones, gets Hargrove. Hargrove gets in the backfield and gets Sean Alexander 33 yards. Not for this guy. This guy's got to get 150 yards.
Well, 3 yards a carry.
Okay.
Total. 3 yards a carry, average 4.8 during the regular season, and that won't get it done. Hasselbeck over the middle, and that one complete to Corin Robinson. Near the 35, it's enough for a first down.
Joe, it just looked like, okay, Hasselbeck looks out to the outside to his left, and he sees Max Strong. He's thinking, no, I'm not throwing to him. He's not going to get the first down. Now I'll go downfield.
You know what makes that play, though, is the job that Walter Jones did, giving him protection. Corin Robinson does a nice job of sitting in the hole also. Both of these quarterbacks, Matt Hasselbeck and Marc Bulger, know exactly where everybody is on the football field.
And now the Rams are going to have to burn another timeout on defense. On first and 10, back to Seattle in a moment.
More Southwest Airlines flights to more places than ever before. America is your backyard.
You are now free to move about the country.
People everywhere are experiencing a breakthrough.
I'm full!
Taco Bell's Big Bell Value Menu featuring the Grande Soft Taco with double the beef and big cheesy taste. To keep your stomach and your wallet full, think outside the bun.
We need a car. A sports car.
A wagon.
Silver.
And certified pre-owned.
That one.
AutoTrader.com lets you compare 2.1 million new, used, and certified pre-owned cars to find the one you want.
Oh, now we gotta sell our car.
I need a car.
AutoTrader.com. Your car is waiting.
Coming to DVD.
Can you be perfect?
Move fast.
That's what I'm talking about!
Play hard. Score big.
Your expectations couldn't be any higher.
One of the greatest sports movies ever made.
Yeah! That's the way they play ball!
Friday Night Lights. On the DVD January 18th.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
St. Louis on top of Seattle, 14-10, but the Seahawks are driving. They have reached the Ram 35-yard line. Matt Hasselbeck, 13 out of 24 after a very slow start.
And some of those incompletions weren't his fault. They were just bouncing off the hands of his receivers.
Hasselbeck out in the flat to Robinson, fumbled the football, out of bounds. What a break for Seattle.
Corin Robinson has had two breaks. He's fumbled the ball twice, and it's went out of bounds. But keeping the drive alive, Matt Hasselbeck does an excellent job on the pass before this. It's third and 13. That's Corin Robinson. That's Max Strong in the backfield. Strong goes out. Robinson hooks. He looks out towards Strong and then fires up the field. Look out to the left, turn, step up, fire the completion for the big first down.
And if you wonder why the ball is second down and about four, you cannot fumble the ball forward.
Alexander hit from behind, dive forward inside the 25.
And
first
get
down.
That yardage. And get that yardage. But that's, you know, this team really is now the Seattle Seahawks offensively. You talk about playing with confidence. Look at this blocking. But I'll tell you one thing about Sean Alexander. He has got quick feet, and he can get back inside and find the hole.
You just have to be careful with him having to carry the ball in his right hand all the time.
Hasselbeck underneath to Atula Mealy. And Mealy close to another first down at the 14.
Guys, you talk about a quarterback. We talk about quarterbacks in a rhythm. Right now, Matt Hasselbeck
is setting his back foot and getting the ball. Watch how quickly this ball comes out of his hand. I mean, it is gone in a heartbeat. Itulu immediately does a great job of getting his head around.
And okay, all right, Sean Alexander. That is Adam Archuleta coming in on the blitz, and he just takes him down.
This will be first down, Seattle near the 10.
Max wrong.
That's your wedge.
The ball.
That's your wedge. Just wedge the middle of the football field, give it to the fullback, and let him get the momentum going.
It will be first and goal from the 9.
Here's one of the things that always amazes me about fullbacks. Well, they touch the ball, what, 4 or 5 times a year? And in a crucial situation, to give it to him and expect him to hold on to the ball.
Max Strong is a special one, though.
Hasselbeck quickly to Jackson. Jackson to the 5.
Boy,
Travis Fisher makes the tackle. But right now, Seattle having everything its way, and this is the essence of that quick passing game.
And have it, and get yourself in a rhythm.
And when we talked to them on Friday, or excuse me, on Thursday, the thing they talked about, and Gil Haskell, their offensive coordinator, told me, when we get an opportunity to get points on the board, we have to score. And I said, do you have to score touchdowns? He says, no, we just got to get points on the board and eat the clock.
Drive approaching 5 minutes. Hasselbeck on the run, buried back at the 7-yard line.
And there was absolutely no one to throw the ball to.
Robert Thomas and Bryce Fisher combined to get him.
Look at here. He's looking for Jackson, and Jackson's on the outside. There's absolutely no place to go. Butler has him covered, but everyone else was covered. Hasselbeck did really the smart thing. Eat the football. The worst you want to come away here is with 3.
See, I really think this is a great throwing formation when you bring in a bunch of tight ends. You bring in a couple of tight ends. Tight end now is in the backfield. He's a viable motion guy. You move people around.
Third and goal.
And now you're going to have more room.
Yes, you are.
That's right.
That gives you 5 more yards of room.
Prior to the snap, full start, 77, offense, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Let me tell you guys, coaches get mad because of a penalty like that, but it's as much on the sideline as it is on the quarterback. If the coach doesn't know what package he wants on the field, it just takes so long to get there. Good job setting by Porkchop Womack, but.
Now third and goal from the 12. Jerry Wunsch, number 70, is in there for the injured. Chris Gray has been taken to the locker room for X-ray. Pretty defensive play by DeJuan Gross, who came over the top and batted it down.
I don't even understand the throw.
Well, forget the throw. If they had any confidence, he'd have intercepted this and gone the other way. He breaks great on this ball. I mean, that's an interception. From a defensive perspective, look, he is right there next to the receiver. This defensive secondary has so few interceptions that I think they're afraid to take a chance and go after the ball.
30-yard field goal try coming. That would make it a 1-point ball game. Brown has already hit from 47. And he's perfect on this one. So with 8:52 to go third quarter, Seattle has cut the lead to 1.
The all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee. With Quadra-Drive 2, our most advanced four-wheel drive system ever, a 5.7-liter Hemi V8, and our new electronic stability program. The off-road legend continues on-road. The all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee Limited, 2005 4x4 of the year.
Flavor, Dr. Pepper. One taste, and you get it.
It's almost as if you can see the future unfolding before you, like a road map that only you can read. You're right where you're supposed to be. It's all opening up. Your steps aren't planned, but somehow every one of them makes perfect sense. So you keep moving, twisting and turning, just action and reaction, defying all obstacles, running towards daylight. The playoffs are where moments are made. What's next?
Wednesday, millions are finding out why Alias gets 4 stars. Cool and sleek. This is Edge of the Seat Flat Out Fun and the best season yet.
I'm not going anywhere.
An all-new Alias, Wednesday 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
We're in the beautiful city of Seattle, where St. Louis leads it by 1 here at Qwest Field. And it's been a problem for the Seahawks in the red zone against the Rams. They've been there 7 times and have only 2 touchdowns to show for it. The other 5 times they had to settle for field goals. Avion Kayson deep for the kick. Across the 30 and rare good starting position for the Rams. Let's go to Susie.
Well, we spent some time with Mike Martz last night. He told us that he is closer to this team than any he's been associated with. And he told us it's because they were babies when they came in. 47% of this team has 3 years or less experience. It's a great opportunity to get them going in the right direction. And he says they're such good guys, kind of an unusual locker room, little division. It's a group that's very connected. They play for each other and they bought into the unselfishness. They really have to rely on each other. They don't want to let each other down.
Susie, I know he gets a lot of grief from people, but is there a more exciting offense to watch anywhere? Bulger, draw play to Jackson. Boy, and Jackson has been sort of reticent to put his shoulder down and go, dancing a little bit. And there is Mike Martz, who was best described, I think, a couple of years ago as a ruthless play caller. If he gets you down by 10 and has a chance to get you down by 20 and then 30, he's going to do it.
But he's very unpredictable as far as down and distances go. He's not afraid to take a shot on 3rd and long, 3rd and short, 2nd and 6. I really believe they have to challenge the secondary again down the field.
Seahawks show blitz and come with it. Jackson on the draw. Got maybe a yard. That's it.
He just changes the pace of the game, Mike Martz does. When you're standing there saying, all right, now, boy, it looks like he's really got him ready to throw, and all of a sudden he'll come out and run 4 plays in a row.
Well, I'll tell you, I like what they just did, Seattle. Kenny Hamlin, number 26, the free safety, came on a blitz, and he's the guy that made the play. I mean, you've got to come from everywhere when you're playing this team. You cannot let Bulger sit in that pocket and get relaxed again.
6 defensive backs on the field for Seattle, and Marc Bulger trying to get Jackson in the right place, and Jackson doesn't want to go.
Made him take their 2nd timeout.
That's the downside for rookies in a complicated offense.
Can inspiration replace the typical small car with something that lives a little larger? More space. More function. More sizzle. America's best small car alternative just got a little better. The Chrysler PT Cruiser. Now starting at just $13,995. Chrysler. Inspiration comes standard.
What's that?
Oh, it's a duvet cover.
A what?
A duvet cover. It's a decorative sham that also protects. Watch the game. The double quarter pounder with cheese. Pound one.
Oh!
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
Watch what? It's a throw pillow.
Here, honey.
Thank you.
Here's your
ticket.
Thank you.
Call me when you get there.
I will.
Tired of waiting for your reward? With Thank You from Citi, you get great rewards that are easy to earn, easy to redeem. That's a card you can count on.
I don't want you here.
Because you still desire me. Wear something more appropriate. Pretend you're a lawyer. You're fired.
My.
What are you going to do, sweetheart? Sue me?
An all-new Boston Legal this Sunday, 10, 9 Central, only on ABC.
7:21 to go, third quarter. It is almost deafening in here. Middle of the period, and St. Louis has already burned two of its timeouts, something we have seen historically from this high-octane offense.
And you just can't keep doing that. It's going to catch up to you sooner or later.
Bulger to Holt, and Torrey Holt will have a first down up at the 46.
How do you quiet 67,000 people?
Just like that.
In a matter of a second.
Just like that. Throw a completion for a first down.
Look at Marc Bulger. Yeah, everything about him is Mr. Cool. And Torrey Holt's the same way. See how he looks in, reads the defense. I really enjoyed the conversation with him last night when he talked about running three or four different kinds of eight patterns. Now, eight patterns are posts, and they're run at different levels, and it's all done by reading.
Five catches, 99 yards for Holt. Bulger wants the screen. Oh. Got it to Jackson, but Jackson didn't have a chance because of Marcus Trufant.
Well, I'll tell you what, O'Keefer is the guy. He is in the backfield. He doesn't take the fake. They run a draw and a fake draw, and they're going to run a screen pass to the outside. O'Keefer stays on the outside, makes his play, and then Trufant makes the tackle. Left of your screen, watch. Boom, that's O'Keefer in his face, and then the throw is made, and Trufant makes the tackle. That's just perfect defense.
And Marshall Faulk is in the game now, and I just think that he's a guy that's got to touch the ball more in this half.
Blitz coming. Bulger unloads to Curtis, looking for a block and has it. Curtis inside the 30 to the 26-yard line. You can blitz, you can get pressure, but if you don't get there, these guys can eat you alive.
He gets the ball. Marc Bulger gets the ball out of his hands so quickly. Watch up top. He sets the quick post. He's inside on Richard, and it's a foot race. And you're not going to win a lot of foot races with Kevin Curtis.
And it's not like Mike Martz doesn't care if Marc Bulger gets hit on the pressure. He just says he can get rid of it so fast to the right guy, they're not going to get there anyway. Bulger under pressure this time, somehow got away, and then doesn't get away the second time. He's nailed at the 28.
I tell you, Chad Brown comes in and drops a shoulder, and he hits Bulger. Number 94 is going to be the guy at the end of this play. Here comes, I'm going to tell you, this is not a blitz either. This is just a four-man rush. Watch that. That's Chad Brown. Here comes the hit. Look, it drops his shoulder.
Oh,
boy, there's
what a
right,
shot.
Right cross.
I mean, that baby hurts.
Nah.
Trust me, that would hurt.
And as a quarterback, the first thing you want to do, straighten your helmet and get up as quick as you can. Even if you can't see, you just
have
to get up.
They're taking their last timeout. I'm sorry, Joe, but this is the last timeout for the Rams.
Well, this may be a timeout called because Marc Bulger is still trying to figure out where he is with 4:41 to go third quarter. We're in Seattle.
Kevin Moss grabs a Snickers to satisfy his hunger. Packed with peanuts, Snickers handles hunger, and now Kevin is up for anything. Feeling rejuvenated, Kevin decides to help his friend Sully move. Sully accidentally drops a couch on Kevin's foot. He screams. A talent agent driving by likes his voice and signs him. Kevin becomes the fifth member of a boy band called Too Hot. He writes a song called I Want to Be Your Resident. An adoring public misinterprets the lyrics, and in an electoral sweep, Kevin Moss is elected president. Eat a Snickers and become president. Make it happen with Snickers.
Your family just got a whole lot bigger. Now that Singular has joined forces with AT&T Wireless to bring you the largest calling community in America. Talk to any Singular or AT&T Wireless customer for free.
Can you ask someone to pass the gravy?
All 46 million of them. Now buy the latest video phone and get one free. Only from the new Singular. Raising the bar.
In 2 days in New York City, America's favorite bachelorette begins her search for love in a two-hour premier event.
New York is the perfect city to fall in love.
Jenna is the all-American girl.
She's cute and sexy all at once.
I had no idea how competitive these guys were.
I will chew him up like a piece of garbage.
This is the most difficult thing, but I'm willing to do it in order to find the man I'm supposed to spend the rest of my life with.
The Bachelorette premieres with a special two-hour event Monday at 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
St. Louis by one, 4:41 to go third quarter. Here's what happened on that last timeout. Marc Bulger using the third and final timeout. You see him signaling, let's get a play in here. Torrey Holt said, come on, you got to get something in. Play clock winding down. Bulger uses a timeout. They have none left. Now if there's a controversial play, they can't challenge it. They're out of timeout.
Well, here's the play before where Chad Brown just unloads on him. And Mike Marks went after the official, said he got hit in the head with an elbow.
This is what happens when you have 200 pass plays in your offense. You can sometimes outsmart yourself. And that's one of the things Mike Marks talked about, trying to do too much as a coach, make too many changes, too many adjustments.
Oh, he got hold of one-on-one on the outside.
Second and 12, blitz coming. Falk, what a cut! Holy cow, Marshall Falk left everybody else standing flat-footed. Are you kidding?
Well, Rocky Bernard, number 99, watch him. He's going to go, I got him. No, I don't have him. Now I got whacked by my own guy.
Ken Hamlin with the same route. Watch number 26 come in late. There's one. There's the other. I think when you're in the playoffs, Marshall Falk has got to get more time on the football field.
Big third down here, third and five. Falk's in there with good speed in the backfield behind Bulger. Bulger underneath Holt. Gave up the first down and then got it back. What a dangerous move by Torrey Holt.
I'll tell you one thing. We're sitting up here looking. You're looking in the middle of the field, and all of a sudden you see a guy on the right-hand side of this field come uncovered. Nobody's around him, and that's number 81, Torrey Holt. How can he be that free? Here he goes. He fakes to the outside. He loses the defensive man. And look at how clear he is. There isn't a green shirt around him. Look at here. Back to the inside, and there's really nobody on him.
Sometimes you have to give credit to a very well-designed route, and that was an excellent route.
Six catches, 108 yards for Holt. Bulger in trouble, and down he goes. Chike Okiefor again has him at the 20. 3 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the first NFL playoff game of the year. And the Rams hanging on to a one-point lead, trying to extend it here, but now facing a second and 19.
This has been a fast third quarter.
And the St. Louis Rams are without their timeouts. They've used everyone up here in the third quarter, which could be a big factor towards the end of this game.
Bulger just throws this one away, making sure he doesn't take the sack or make the big mistake down here.
See, having the Rams in third down and 20 or 19, to me, is a scary proposition, because now, if you play the zone like they did early in the game on the first drive, he hits Torrey Holt in the middle of the football field, behind the linebackers, in front of the safeties. You've got a rookie safety in Michael Boulware playing there, and that's the guy I think they would want to try and isolate.
The Rams could conceivably get a first down. It would be inside the one-yard line. Bulger to the end zone, too high for Holt, into a double team. Lucas was there. And Chris Richard was there. And here comes the field goal unit.
This is just outstanding coverage on. Look at this. Torrey Holt goes in and he runs right into the safety. I mean,
This is outstanding coverage, but Isaac Bruce was open.
And Kenny Lucas got his hands on him. He's going to have to be careful. You can't touch the receivers downfield when the ball's in the air.
Jeff Wilkins from 38 yards. And the Rams regain a four-point advantage, 17-13 in Seattle, 2:35 to go, third quarter. Check in with Susie.
Well, Mike, the Rams looking for that three-game sweep of Seattle on the first possession. Marc Bulger was a perfect 4-for-4, and he ended by going to Torrey. Big game hold, who's been huge game, 6 catches, 108 yards. The Seahawks answered with a Josh Brown field goal, and then it was Marshall Faulk walking in from the one. Matt Hasselbeck keeping him in it, hits his veteran Bobby Engram for the touchdown. Another Josh Brown field goal. Jeff Wilkins adds one more, and that's where we stand in the third quarter, 17-13 Rams.
All right, Susie, 2:35 to go, third quarter. Seattle has evened up the statistical battle, and it's only 4 points on the scoreboard.
Why is it every year when we get a wild card game, it's always a great one?
It's a wild one.
That's right, it is. That's why they're called wild card games.
I'll tell you, a lot of times, I mean, I think the Jets and San Diego game, remember, Jets beat San Diego earlier this year, one of the few teams that was able to do that. What's the weather going to be like in San Diego? It's a beautiful day here in Seattle, though.
How many times do you get to say that? It's a beautiful day here in Seattle, and it's raining cats and dogs in San Diego.
25 regular season games played at this stadium, and they've never had bad weather.
Morris from the 6. Cut down at the 24. Last season in the playoffs, the Seahawks and the Packers ended regulation tied, and a very confident Matt Hasselbeck guaranteed a Seattle score during the overtime coin toss. Not a good move. Then the Packers' Al Harris intercepts Hasselbeck and returns it for a touchdown in a 33-27 win.
And that stays with you through the entire offseason. It's the last throw that you made in that year of 03. It's the last throw, and today is a tremendous opportunity to put that pass far, far behind you.
Screen to Alexander. Nice run by Sean Alexander up near midfield as Tommy Polley went after the football. Not only didn't get that, he didn't get Alexander.
Well, you want to see a play that you don't ever want to see when you're in the meeting room with the players. Antoine Edwards, number 42. Watch the move that Alexander does on him. Not there, right here. Bink, back inside. And all you got was the one arm on him, and you're not going to bring Alexander down with one arm.
And anytime you drop your head trying to make a tackle, 95% of the time you're coming up with a half a leg and a lot of air.
First catch for Seattle running back. Morris was the man in motion. Hasselbeck looks one way, throws the other, and Fisher just unloads on Darryl Jackson. 7 catches, 62 yards this afternoon. Good game for Jackson.
And here comes Hasselbeck with that efficiency again. He just seems to get himself into a rhythm. And when he does, he looks to the sidelines and he's saying, hey, Mike, give me the play.
Well, he
give it to me a little sooner.
That's why Mike Holmgren wanted him from the Packers. He wanted him to be
exactly his
quarterback.
And coaches get into that rhythm calling plays as well. Alexander stood straight up by Pickett and Archuleta.
Sean Alexander cannot have the impact for the Seattle offense that he has had all year because of that sore wrist. Everything he's doing, he's either protecting a little bit when he's running or having to protect the football in an uncomfortable way, carrying it just in his right arm. So he's about, I'd say, 85% of where he was coming into this ball game.
Morris checks in for him on 3rd and 4, time running out, third quarter. Hasselbeck under pressure, throws underneath. That'll be a first down. Jackson with another catch.
Oh, what a beautiful throw. You know, we're talking about rhythm and where he steps up, gets planted, and Hasselbeck throws the ball. Just look at this pass. This pass is absolutely perfect. He is the only guy, Jackson is the only one that can get there. Butler had no chance.
What's surprising is Matt Hasselbeck's completion percentage is below 60%. He's 58.9. And when you see the way he sets and the rhythm that he gets in sometimes, you scratch your head and say, how?
That's the end of the third quarter. The Rams lead the Seahawks 17-13. ABC's NFL Wildcard Saturday continues after this from our ABC station.
Friday, the president, the first lady, in their first interview since the election. And who are they talking with? Barbara Walters returns to 2020 for an exclusive interview from the White House. How have the Bushes changed? Don't miss 2020, Friday at 10, 9 Central.
This is the Toyota Highlander. You can get it with seating for 7. And you can lease it for $259 a month for 36 months with $1,869 due at signing. See? In beautiful black and white. If a down payment doesn't work for you, you can lease a Highlander for $289 a month. An extra $30 a month, but you drive away paying nothing except the first month's payment. That's it. You want one? See your Toyota dealer.
The Highlander, one of 17 Toyotas, moving you forward.
Now you can get great-tasting steak without a grill. Introducing the new Steak, Egg, and Cheese Breakfast Sandwich from Dunkin' Donuts, served on a freshly baked bagel. Have your steak in the morning and give your grill the day off. Dunkin' Donuts, bring yourself back.
Critics are raving about Covad VoIP.
Roll going to jail.
There was nothing we could do.
It had to be done.
Richard Parks.
CFO, you're a joke.
Shut up, Richard!
If there's one thing you throw out this fiscal quarter, make it your old phone system. Get your free voice assessment today.
Watch Liz Cho only on Eyewitness News.
Ready to start the fourth quarter in Seattle, where the Seahawks are down by only 4. 20 years since the last postseason win. They beat the Los Angeles Raiders in 1984.
Alexander.
For those of you who are wondering, yes, Jerry Rice plays on the Seattle Seahawks football team. And yes, Jerry Rice has been on the field for most of their offense. And no, they have not thrown one ball in his direction.
Very unusual role for Jerry Rice to be a part of an offense through three quarters and not have a pass thrown to you. But a credit to his professionalism is he continues to run the routes hard and help this ball club.
Hasselbeck, the out.
Oh,
Jackson, that should be another first down.
Whoa. I'll tell you what, I got to see this again for this mark. You got to understand something. Jackson is coming back to the ball. Let's just take a look at that line is not really true. All right, he's up in the air. And now if he comes down on about the 25-yard line.
But keep in mind, the Rams do not have the ability to challenge, so it wouldn't matter because he could challenge the mark.
Hasselbeck again goes for the end zone. Jackson, touchdown.
That looked like the same route that we saw Bobby Engram make the touchdown reception on in the first half.
He beat DeJuan Gross by 2 steps. 10 catches, 106 yards for Darryl Jackson.
Starting from the right side, you see him. There he is, coming across in the route. Now there it is again. DeJuan Gross was the same guy that they beat with the same route, but with a different person earlier in the game.
How about the throw, man?
Oh, beautiful throw. He's hot. And Darryl Jackson was the same guy that started the game running down the field and not even turning his head around to see where the ball was. He certainly changed that pattern.
Mm-hmm.
multifunctional element from Honda. Where will it take you?
Cold Hard Facts. As the Super Bowl approaches, millions of bottles of refreshing frost-brewed Coors Light will be tackled. Fans will get in touch with their inner linebacker. Grown men will dance. Games will be won. Voices will be lost. And tons of lucky hot dogs will be washed down by Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, the coldest tasting beer in the world and the official beer sponsor of Super Bowl 39.
It is a big, big night here in Times Square. Listen to that.
Sorry.
Pause and rewind live TV with a DirecTV DVR with TiVo. Sign up now and get one for under $50. Call 1-800-DIRECTV today.
In 2 days, they'll be holding, scoring, illegal forward passes, all committed by 25 tight ends. Don't miss the 2-hour season premiere of The Bachelorette, Monday at 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Seattle, to the delight of 76,000, has taken the lead 20-17 here at home. 7 plays, 76 yards, 3 minutes and 52 seconds. Hasselbeck to Jackson for the touchdown. And Darryl Jackson with 10 catches, 106 yards, a Seahawk record in a playoff game. Kaysan to the 30.
I want you to notice what Darryl Jackson does, but I want you to pay attention to Jerry Rice. That's Darryl Jackson. That's Jerry Rice. Jerry Rice is going to go down and clean out both of the defenders, and Darryl Jackson is just going to go right across the field to the voided area. This is the job that Jerry Rice does, running hard, taking the defenders. It allows Darryl Jackson to go into a voided area in front of DeJuan Gross and wind up with the touchdown. Nice throw also by Matt Hasselbeck. Ties his career high. 10 catches.
Steven Jackson, the running back behind Bulger. Isaac Bruce at the 37-yard line, only his second catch today.
I like, you know, Isaac Bruce. You want to know why he's been around and catches so many balls?
Why?
Because when Isaac Bruce catches a ball, there's no reason for him to take a big blast and get one more yard. He knows he has no room to run. He just catches the ball and goes right down. Now it's second down, he can play another play.
Jackson.
Oh, what a nice job by Chad Brown. Just a really nice job. You don't have to go up and lay a big hit on people. Sometimes all you need to do is use your hands, keep the blocker away from you, and just slide them right out of bounds.
And they're about 2 yards shy.
Look at that. Does a great job with Adam Timmerman coming around, trying to block him, but he can't get the outside.
Third and two, and on third down, Marc Bulger has converted 75% of the time. Jackson, first down. And they do it the old-fashioned, the non-Ram way on the ground.
Well, I'll tell you what, you want Jackson on that last play. Steven Jackson just showed you how much power he really has. This is a big man, because he was hit in the backfield and still picked up 4 yards on the play.
Now he's almost a full yard below his average. He averaged 5 yards a carry, which was the league leading average this year. So the Seahawks, from a running standpoint, are doing a good job.
First down, Rams at the 43. Bulger with plenty of time, tipped it incomplete. Bruce got a hand on it. Curtis was also in the area.
I'll tell you what, I see a lot of patterns this team has, but I don't ever remember seeing two guys in the same spot. And when you do that, you have a whole lot of green shirts in the same area.
They're crisscrossing in the middle. When Marc Bulger throws the ball in the middle of the football field, it's almost like watching Michael Jordan take a jump shot. You just hold your breath, because it's either going to wind up beautifully landing in someone's hands, or there's going to be, like Paul mentioned, a lot of people moving through one little area.
Second and 10. Play fake to Jackson. Bulger with time underneath, and there's that man, Chad Brown, again.
You're
going to
have
Mono Maliuna.
You're going to have Kenny Lucas again, and it's totally away from the play. He is on Isaac Bruce, and they threw a flag over here, and that
illegal contact, 21, defense, 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Boy, you got to have him in third and 10 situation, and Kenny Lucas.
Remember, in the playoffs last year is where the rule emphasis was created. Walt Coleman's group, he was the referee in the Indianapolis game.
Where guys were
being mugged with Indianapolis and New England. And it's a rule emphasis that's out there. And I'm just wondering how it will play out through the entire playoff picture, not just in our game. We've seen it play a part in this one already.
And Seattle has done a brilliant job all year long, the least penalized team in the NFL. They've been hurt today. Falk. Marshall Falk into Seattle territory inside the 48-yard line.
I tell you, Chike O'Keefer has played one heck of a football game for the Seattle Seahawks at the defensive end position. He's put a lot of pressure on Bulger. He's run down runners. That was a nice tackle by Marshall Falk, because they're blitzing up the middle. And if he doesn't make this play, there he is up against the tight end outside. Marshall Falk's got a lot of green in front of him if he doesn't make that tackle.
Second and 6. Bulger under pressure to the sideline and out of bounds. First down, Isaac Bruce.
Oh, I tell you what, just when you watch Bulger, you know, we've been talking all night about him knowing where everyone is on this football field. And I can assure you that Isaac Bruce wasn't his number one target. If he was anything, he was third. Isaac Bruce will go down. Look at this. But you look at the time that Bulger has. He just finds Bruce because he was looking at Torrey Holt. He also looked at Marshall Falk. Then he came back over here.
That looked like one of those moves that they make on that turf. That quick stop turnaround. Here I am.
And the same kind of move he fell down on in the first half. Bulger pump fake. Goes deep. Bruce out of bounds.
Another flag.
Another flag.
They'll call it again. It's the pump and go. And the rules are set up for you to get called.
Illegal contact. 23, defense. 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
9 out of 10 times, if a receiver runs a pump and go and you're going man-to-man, that's the situation. Marcus Trufant, there's the little out. There's the... Guys. Yeah. I mean, he doesn't put a hand on him.
That's a bad call.
Boy, tough to find any contact.
This is what scares me a little bit about the playoffs and this rule emphasis. Are the officials going to be deciding factors in whether teams advance or not? Or is it going to be the play of the teams on the field? That's the thing that scares me with this rule emphasis.
4 flags for illegal contact on the secondary. Falk, another great cut. Marshall Falk down to the 17-yard line. Well, there's still something left in the tank, isn't there?
He's living for this game.
Well, I'll tell you what, he makes a move back to the inside, and that is O'Keefer going down the field. He is being blocked, but he never sees that move that Marshall makes back to the outside, and there wasn't a linebacker there.
Doing it for a long, long time. His 11th year out of San Diego State, one of the best that ever played the game. Very patient drive for the Rams. You don't say that very often. Bulger under pressure. He can run. inside the 10, slides at the 9.
Michael, that patience has been helped an awful lot by a couple of penalties by the Seahawks in very crucial and critical situations. And if you throw the ball as much as the Rams do, if you're not getting called for holding penalties, you're going to get some breaks. Good decision. Nice job again. The Seahawks basically do a nice job of covering. There you see Trufant staying away from him, but he's in his hip pocket. Bulger's forced to take off and run.
They marked the ball at the 10 where Bulger started his slide. Second and 3. Jackson. They're very hesitant. Picked up maybe one. They need to reach the 7 for a first down.
I'll tell you what, you want to talk about a guy, we talked to Mike Martz about him last night, with a lot of guts, is Tom Newton, number 61, the left guard. This guy is, I mean, he's just
hurt, right?
Oh yeah,
playing
he's hurt.
On one leg.
He limps back in and out of the huddle. But watch that ball, well watch him, he comes up the line of scrimmage, he's limping. Now when that ball is snapped, he is popping.
Sprained left knee. They have had offensive linemen beaten to a pulp all year. Bulger. Knocked away, almost intercepted. Intended for the tight end, Manamaliuna, and Bulger almost picked it.
But T.K. O'Keefer again is the one that gets in Bulger's face. Look at number 56. He's forcing him to make the throw, and you see Michael Bulger cuts right in front. If Manamaliuna doesn't really hit him from behind, he probably would pick it off.
Wilkins will come on for a 27-yard field goal try. He's hit from 38. And we are tied in Seattle with 8:07 to go in the first playoff game of the year.
Invention is greater than convention. Moving forward is greater than sitting still. Simple is greater than complex. Greater power, greater technology, greater beauty. The all-new Audi A6. It's greater to lead than follow.
Another moment. Go to Cialis.com and find out what the Cialis Promise Program can mean for you. It's an offer you won't want to miss. Are you ready?
Hi, may I take your order?
I'd like a classic single combo, but instead of fries, I'd like a baked potato.
No problem.
Introducing combo choices only from Wendy's. You can choose fries, chili, a baked potato, side or Caesar side salad at no extra cost. Dave Thomas always said, people like a choice. So choose Wendy's. It's better here. Our pickup window is open till midnight or later.
In Good Company is without a doubt the year's surprise hit comedy.
What a kung fu grip you got there, Dan.
Newsweek raves, in a holiday movie season up to its neck in darkness, this nimble comedy is a welcome respite. In Good Company, rated PG-13, in theaters Friday.
Wednesday, millions are finding out why Alias gets 4 stars. Cool and sleek. This is edge of the seat, flat out fun. And the best season yet.
I'm not going anywhere.
An all-new Alias, Wednesday 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
What a great ball game. 8:07 to go in the playoffs from Seattle. St. Louis and the Seahawks deadlocked at 20 apiece.
Michael, we're midway through the fourth quarter, and both of these teams have only had 2 drives this half. St. Louis, 23 plays in 2 drives. Seattle, 21 plays in 2 drives. That's ball control.
For St. Louis, it's amazing.
Yes.
Morris from the 1. Swallowed up at the 20. The Rams special teams, maligned all year, done a pretty good job today.
Cold hard fact. The higher the elevation, the lower the temperature. That's why every single Coors Light is born right here in the Rockies. And when beer starts out this cold, it ends up this refreshing. Coors Light, our goal, the coldest tasting beer in the world.
Where are Nigel and Trevor?
They're testing the vehicle stability control on the Lexus.
Any news?
The powerful allure of the new RX, continuing to put the world on notice.
Cold hard fact. Only Coors Light is frost brewed at ice cold temperatures. Stored cold and shipped cold. And when beer starts out this cold, it ends up this refreshing. Coors Light, our goal, the coldest tasting beer in the world.
NFL youth football teaches you skills like teamwork, leadership, respect, confidence, and courage. Life skills. Collect them all. To find out how NFL youth football programs do more than just teach you to play, log on to NFLyouthFootball.com.
ABC's coverage of the NFL playoffs brought to you by the coldest tasting beer in the world, Coors Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL. State Farm, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Wendy's new combo choices. Wendy's, it's better here. And Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you. Today's aerial coverage provided by Anheuser-Busch over the beautiful Qwest Field in Seattle.
Corin Robinson is on the field for the Seahawks, and remember, he's fumbled twice today. Fortunately, one went out of bounds, the other he managed to recover.
Hasselbeck, who's had good protection, now on a run, throws a Tulumili, bulldozes his way outside of the 40. Now, first, 22-yard game play.
Well, this is Hasselbeck. It's at his best. But Mealy at the end, you watch when he catches this ball. Look at Hasselbeck. Dodge knows where he has to. Watch Mealy. At the end of this play, you talk about extra yards. These are his.
Hasselbeck really tearing it up in the second half. He has only missed two passes. Robbie Toback, the starting center, mic'd up for Seattle, trying to fire up this offense.
Man, I am tired of field goals. Let's get some sevens up there, man. Let's get some sevens. Yeah, let's go win this thing now. Hey, let's go win this thing. It don't, nothing else matters. Let's go win this thing. 0-0, baby. Let's do it.
Robbie Toback was in junior high school the last time this team won a playoff game.
Well, he's right about the 0-0, but there happens to be 20, a 2 in front of both of them.
Hasselbeck with time underneath to Jackson. Can't get much out of this because of Tommy Polley. Let's go to Susie.
Well, you're watching Robbie Toback. That offensive line, they are an exclusive group. And since Matt arrived in Seattle, he has worked really hard to be accepted by that group, telling us that probably has something to do with watching Brett Favre in Green Bay. He and his center, Frank Winters, were inseparable. Matt naturally drawn to these guys, and they've accepted him as one because he gets in defenders' faces, he plays hurt, toughness, they love that. Total control in the offense. Toback really loves the guy.
All right, Susie, third and 7 here. Huge play as we approach the 6-minute mark. Hasselbeck trying to change the play. Rams show blitz and come with it. Hasselbeck throws, knocked away. Jeremetrius Butler was right there with Jackson.
And that was not a typical Matt Hasselbeck throw. That one he had to wait a little bit more. It was out of rhythm, and he hung it up a little bit behind Jackson. And that's why he's upset with himself. We've seen how hot he is in the second half. Over the last 4 games of the season, he's completed almost 72% of his passes.
That was tipped a little bit, too.
For 10 touchdowns and 4 interceptions, but that one wasn't quite the way he wanted.
Walter to kick to Sean McDonald. He has to go all the way back to his 10. low returnable kick. McDonald from the 14 has a seam. And got back to the 22 before he is drilled. Marc Bulger got off to such a hot start. Can he get it back and bring the Rams a playoff victory?
Introducing the unusually versatile, sport-tuned Kia Spectra 5. Hook up with one.
ABC rings in a new year with a celebration of outstanding all-new television.
Wow.
Sunday, a widow and her daughter's dreams went up in smoke.
These women are basically living outdoors.
Now our team travels to the most remote place yet to give this family a New Year's miracle. An all-new Extreme Makeover Home Edition, 8, 7 Central. Then, the series nominated for 5 Golden Globes.
Oh, well.
The Sunday sensation America can't resist.
I thought you said you were separated.
Oh, we are. He just lives here because his mistress refuses to care for him.
An all-new Desperate Housewives, 9, 8 Central. And...
what's your name, fella?
Candace Bergen joins TV's most talked-about law firm.
She's still hot.
Nominated for 2 Golden Globes.
Imagine the fun working together.
It won't be fun.
An all-new Boston Legal, 10, 9 Central. Sundays on ABC, the place everyone wants to be.
Oh.
A great new year of television. Sunday, only on ABC.
My.
Al Michaels and John Madden standing by. The second half of our wild card Saturday doubleheader from San Diego. They'll have the NFL's top rusher, Curtis Martin, and the Jets against Drew Brees and the AFC West champion Chargers next here on ABC.
Well, you want to talk about some running backs in that game. Wow.
Marc Bulger trying to lead his offense. Chad Brown doing everything defensively can to stop him. Bulger got off to such a great start. Only 6 out of 10 since. Marshall Faulk, the running back, lowers his shoulder, running hard out to the 29.
This is going to be this section of the game right now, we will see the management skills of Mike Martz. How quickly does he want to move the ball down the field? There's 5 minutes, 20 seconds left. He has no timeouts, so he's going to force Seattle to use his if he can eat up some clock and get in position. Remember, they only need a field goal, attempt to win this ball game.
Faulk again, and Seattle swarms on Marshall Faulk. They need to reach the 34 for a first down. It will be a big third and short coming.
Well, you got Tom Newton, who's down now, and you know, this guy
has been a warrior.
Oh,
right, Paulie.
Man, I tell you, I've been watching him all night long, limp in and out of the huddle. They have no idea how he's playing. Mike Martz even told us last night. He said we have no idea how this guy plays, but.
He's wearing a brace on that knee. One ligament is totally gone. The other one is sprained. And Mike Martz said we're only going into this game with 6.5 linemen to start with. Newton being the half because he's limping on one leg. They've hit injury problems up front all year long, starting with Kyle Turley at the beginning of the season.
Well, he has to go off because there's a timeout here. But I'm going to tell you something. To me, this is when the St. Louis Rams are the most dangerous. You've got them in a 3rd and 2.5-2 situation. And with all of their weapons and the things that they do, to me, that's scary.
Yeah, but I still think that the first concern of Mike Martz has got to be to pick up the first down. Don't worry. Now, they could throw a 15-yard in. That's his idea of picking up 3 yards.
That's what I'm saying.
But you really have to get the yardage.
Well, we have a moment. We would like to thank our entire Sunday Night Football production team bringing you today's telecast, led by our producer, Jay Rothman, our director, Chip Dean, our technical director, Mark Herklotz, and thanks to our executive producer, Jed Drake, also here with us in Seattle today, the senior vice president of ESPN's programming and production, Mark Quinzel, the executive producer of ABC Sports, is Mike Pearl, and to all the people who have worked with us all year long, our deepest appreciation. Mark Fredrickson, our statistician, Dave Dara, our spotter, Alex Stern from Elias Sports, and Nancy Volker, our stage manager, and about 100 other folks.
You bet, you bet.
Huge play, third and two for the Rams. Bulger out in the flat, first down and more, McDonald. Holy cow, what a play.
And you know, throwing him down out of bounds.
That
like
should have been another 15 yards.
I mean, as far as the game goes from an officiating standpoint, they're letting these guys play with the emotions in this game.
How about that for a play call? McDonald had not made a catch the entire game. This is 31 yards.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, look at McDonald comes out of the backfield. I said, on third and two, this is when they're the most dangerous. Cool. Because you plan on him running the ball, get the first down. But take a look at here. Now you're throwing him out of bounds, and I agree.
How is that not 15 yards, Paul?
Ken Hamlin does it. I don't know why the officials are standing right there. It should have been.
It's a huge play nonetheless for the Rams. They have it at the 37, first and 10. Bulger underneath. Curtis taken down at the 24.
Now here's the thing, if you're the Seattle Seahawks, you have your timeouts. So you have the full complement of the three timeouts. You also have the 2-minute warning in your favor. Right now you can still play some defense. I don't think you start to use them. But once this thing gets down to 3:30, Mike Holmgren's got to start thinking about how he wants to use the timeouts.
Curtis has gone over the 100-yard mark with his fourth catch. It's just amazing to watch these guys play. Every time you think you got them where you want them, kaboom.
No, they got you where they want you.
And the Seahawks have let a couple games get away from them in the fourth quarter this
year. Including the first game they played against this team. Falk near the 20. And the clock continues to churn.
See, this is a great call. This is a great call because it puts him in second down and six. But the best part about this call is it's going to run a lot of clock off. And what they're trying to do, and Martz is trying to do, is like Joe was talking about a moment ago. Let's force them, Holmgren and the Seattle Seahawks, to take a timeout, which he hasn't done yet. But he will inside when they get inside 3 minutes.
Well, after this play, I think he's going to be forced to use one of his timeouts.
Of course, you don't want to burn them too early either.
Yeah, but, and you don't want to give up a touchdown. A field goal, you got a better chance of having an opportunity to tie.
There's a lot of things you don't want to do right now. Falk dancing. Ducks between tacklers, reaches the 17-yard line. They have to get to the 14 for a first down, so there will be another big third down coming.
I don't agree with this. I think they should take a timeout here.
I find it interesting that they're letting the clock run down.
Well, they got to run a play before the 2 minutes. That's probably what he's thinking about. And then they'll take a timeout right after that and get to the 2 minutes. They still have two.
They better figure out how to stop them from picking up this first down first.
The Rams, 8 out of 13 on third down today. Play action, Bulger over the middle. Touchdown! The tight end, Cam Cleland. Are you kidding?
What a way to have your first catch.
He's only caught 7 balls all during the regular season.
Did you see the look on Mike Martz's face? You know, he called the play. He just said, hey, I called this play. Nobody's paying attention to Cam Cleland. Look at him go down the middle of the field. I mean, you don't expect him to throw there, and they do.
To me, that is such a gutsy call
against
this situation.
But it's against a rookie middle linebacker, Ketavides. He gets turned around, and Mike Martz absolutely loves what he saw. And Marc Bulger actually showed some emotion.
So many weapons. And 27 points now for the St. Louis Rams, who have taken the lead. In NFL history, 8 teams have made the playoffs without a winning record. And the St. Louis Rams are one of them. None has ever won a postseason game, but this is not your typical 8-8 team. Bulger literally missed 3 games with a bad shoulder. They lost 2 of those that he didn't start. They could conceivably be 10-6 coming in here.
Now you spin it forward and you look at the Seattle Seahawks on offense, you say, okay, what are they going to have to do against this Ram defense? I think, first of all, they're going to have to catch the football. You can't drop it. You're going to have the two-minute warning, plus you're going to have the three timeouts. So time is not necessarily going to be a factor. They're going to need bigger chunks than 6 yards, though.
You know what the factor is? You see that seven up there?
Yeah.
Above that zero?
They got to go get it.
That's what the factor is.
Go get it to OT.
The Rams today have scored on drives of 75 yards, 75 yards, and 76 yards.
Now keep in mind, the Seattle defense had allowed only one drive all year in 16 games for 80 yards or more for a touchdown.
Can they end the drought, the longest in the NFL? It's been since 1984.
Seattle was in an overtime situation against Green Bay last year. Can they get it there this year?
Morris and Evans are deep. Very short kick. Morris from the 15. Straight up the middle, the best return of the day, up to the 36-yard line. And Morris is hurt. Eric Flowers was in on the special teams tackle. And Morris doubled over as he comes off the field. The pressure falls squarely on Matt Hasselbeck, Sean Alexander, and the offense of the Seattle Seahawks. Mike Holmgren, who won the division at 9-7.
Now here's the situation. You've got Sean Alexander, who's got a sore wrist. We just saw Maurice Morris go off the field, and he's kneeling down on the bench, and they're working on him. So both of your running backs are not in the best of shape.
Four-man rush. Hasselbeck over the middle. He has really worked his tight ends very effectively. And Tula Mealy with another catch. He's already down to the Rams 46. We've got a timeout. The two-minute warning at 1:59.
Cold hard facts. As the Super Bowl approaches, millions of bottles of refreshing frost-brewed Coors Light will be tackled. Fans will get in touch with their inner linebacker. Grown men will dance. Games will be won. Voices will be lost. And tons of lucky hot dogs will be washed down by Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, the coldest tasting beer in the world and the official beer sponsor of Super Bowl 39.
She had her license for 45 minutes.
And two accidents in less than 10 seconds.
Two.
I'm State Farm Agent Kevin Weber, and this is a true story.
Yeah, I was scared. I didn't want to call my parents.
I called her parents.
He really treated her like she was his own daughter.
I handled her claim and gave her a few pointers.
A lot of pointers.
A lot of pointers. Any insurance company can promise you a good price, but nobody takes care of you like State Farm. We'd love to prove it to you. Call an agent today.
Like a good neighbor.
State Farm is there.
Wow. How'd this happen?
I told them if they shoveled, I'd let them use their new phones to talk to their friends as much as they want.
They can do that anyway. We've got the Verizon Wireless Family Share Plan with the N.
Yeah, well, they don't know that.
Looks cold.
It's freezing. I ain't going out there.
Sign up for the Family Share Plan, and the whole family can make unlimited in calls to each other and any other Verizon Wireless customer from within the America's Choice coverage area. Plus, don't miss our great deals on camera phones starting at just $29.99.
Hurt myself.
Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
He is on fire.
This is the way to start it.
NFL Wild Card Saturday continues with Jets versus Chargers next on ABC.
The game is on the line for the Seahawks. They are down 27-20 with 1:59 to go.
How many times have you ever heard this? The game is on the line and Jerry Rice is not on the field.
Not very often in 20 years.
They got speed out there now.
First and 10 from the 46.
Corin Robinson's got to step up for the Seahawks in this situation.
Offensive line has done a good job. Jackson right through his hands again. That's the way he started the game. Well, and that baby just whistled through there.
Well, this is a situation where you're running before you get the football. And this is what Joe said before when they took the ball. The first thing he said is that the receivers have to hold on to the football. I don't care if it's a 3-yard gain and you might have a chance to break it. You've got to catch the football.
There's the drop balls. The first one was intercepted that Darryl Jackson dropped. We've seen others go on the ground, but
What a time to drop one.
You're definitely in four down territory, but still.
Hasselbeck underneath to Jackson. He didn't drop this one. To the 25.
How about Mike Holmgren? Here's a guy that's put two balls on the ground, critical drops, and yet he just keeps calling his number. I mean, that's a heck of a call by the coach.
Well, look what happens here. They get him outside. Adam Archuleta was inside, and then he dropped back to the outside. They even had a linebacker there, and they still couldn't stop the play.
12 catches, 128 yards for Jackson. Hasselbeck under pressure. Atula Mealy again. It's the Atula Mealy Daryl Jackson show.
You know, guys, I still think you have, if you're Mike Holmgren, you have to be conscious of the amount of time left in this game. I don't think you can score and leave the Rams with a minute. I really think you've got to take this thing down as far as you can. You've got plenty of timeouts and pick your spots, but don't leave a lot of time on that clock for that Ram offense.
I'm gonna tell you
six
right now,
catches, 98 for Tula Mealy.
I disagree. I think you got to put that ball in the end zone when you can, and if it's right now, do it.
Hasselbeck goes down at the 18-yard line. Finally, some pressure. Jimmy Kennedy, the second-year defensive tackle out of Penn State, gets the sack.
See, these are the things that can happen if you're sitting there thinking, and I really don't believe that a coach is going to say, well, okay, we got to run 25 seconds off and then score. You score whenever you can. Because here are the bad things that can happen.
Well, when I talked to Gil Haskell, their offensive coordinator, one of their concerns regarding the Rams was their front four. Jimmy Kennedy, drafted an 03 first round pick. Ryan Pickett, drafted an 01 first round pick. You've got Robert Thomas, their middle linebacker, drafted an 02 first round pick. Damian Lewis, the other tackle, first round pick in 01. Defensive line, they got a bunch of number ones that can bring it if you get stuck that way.
But that offensive line has done a tremendous job today. Leonard Little, with all that speed from the outside, hasn't gotten a sniff.
And the quarterbacks have done an unbelievable job. Look at the playoff record for Hasselbeck, 329.
Most important 17 yards still in front of him.
Well, I'll tell you something. And every time that Sean Alexander has kind of drifted out of the backfield, they really haven't had anybody on him.
Hasselbeck goes for the end zone. Very fortunate that Jackson was able to get back there and make sure that Travis Fisher didn't get a shot at that one.
Try a little pump and go, and you know it's third down. You know you have to try and get it down to the 1 foot line if you want to get a first down.
Well, Travis Fisher wasn't buying.
My boy's over here looking for a first down on the 1 foot line.
Well, I've been looking at it. They could.
How about a touchdown?
That'd be nice too.
Boy, he really doesn't want to score early.
I'm beyond
that.
To get
a first down.
Okay, I'm beyond the scoring. They've got to get in the end zone now.
Third down. Four man rush, no pressure. Underneath Ingram, taken down at the 5. It will be fourth down and 4.
It'll be overtime, possibly, or else it'll be the Seahawks suffering another defeat. But what a job this offensive line did, Paul. You talked about it.
Well, you know, and look at this. They're waiting on Bobby Ingram to come underneath. And look what the Rams did. I like what they did defensively. They played everybody back on the goal line to come up when the catch is made.
How about this throw, that little flickety sidearm throw that Hasselbeck puts out? This is it. This is where you go to the coach and give me your best play.
And actually, they were very fortunate that the umpire, Carl Paganelli, still has some quicks and ducked, because that ball could have easily hit him and been an incompletion.
Yeah, he brings that thing down from the side to make the throw. Now, Mike Holmgren's got to have the play. Every coach has got the play.
This is it.
The guys have to block it up front. Mike Holmgren saying, okay, our defense has got to come up with a play. Leonard Little has not been heard of all day long.
Conceivably, you could get a first down, but it would be right at the goal line. Hasselbeck, room to run. Now he throws. Incomplete. Intended for Ingram.
Boy, will there be a lot of second guessers on this baby, because when you take a look at it, did he have a chance to make it if he ran?
I thought he did, Paul.
Well, I'm going to tell you what.
I think
those white
shirts.
Yeah, those white shirts close in a hurry. Now, Bobby Engram, number 84, is the guy that he was looking at. Here's the throw, sidearm throw to Bobby Engram. This ball hits him in the hands, and he drops the football. That is a hard catch anyway. But the question is, did Hasselbeck have any room? Look at this.
I think that, Paul.
That ball should have been caught.
You know, you're a receiver in the National Football League. There's, to me, if it's this kind of a situation in a game, it touches your hands.
You got to catch it.
Oh.
And that is just heartbreak for Matt Hasselbeck and Mike Holmgren, not to mention Bobby Engram. Mike Holmgren is as respected, well-liked a coach as there is on the planet. And if anybody up here is thinking Mike Holmgren should not be back as the coach of this franchise, I think they're nuts.
This is a very young football team. A Pro Bowl quarterback, a Pro Bowl running back, a very young defensive secondary. Mike Holmgren has just started to build this football team. They will be back in the playoffs a year from now again.
A crushing loss for Seattle. The Rams beat the Seahawks 27-20. We'll be back from Seattle after this from our ABC station.